At least Hartford, Connecticut, home of UConn football. Today the Huskies look for their first win of the season against FIU of Conference USA. College football on CBS Sports Network presented by the Home Depot. Panthers off to a great 2-1 start. Dave Ryan alongside Christian Fourier, two-time Super Bowl champ of the Patriots. Keanu Martin on the field as well. What a start for Kewan Jenkins, Christian, and the FIU offense moments ago marching up the field. Six plays, 75 yards, 2.5 minutes, and a Bush push TD.
Yeah, that was not what I think anyone expected on the UConn sideline. Everything they did worked. He had a big run by Jenkins. He had a big pass, two passes by Jenkins to the same tight end, McDonald, up the seam. It was basically the same play. The UConn defense is so nervous about the quarterback running that they're almost too aggressive, which allows that tight end to just go right behind those linebackers.
Chase Gabriel just had the PAT a moment ago for FIU. Kicks off here. New returner, Brian Domino. And Victor Rosa deep to receive for the Huskies. Domino looks for his first touch of his career. Freshman. He'll bring it out from the four. Gets to the 21. Home Depot, new project, smarter, Christian. What a first drive for the Panthers.
Well, just like you draw it up, first play. Well, there's Lawrence right there, the big back. That's the bell cow right there. It's hard to take him down. And then he had a couple passes. Here's the second one to McDonald, right up the seam, just a play action pass. And then here comes the touchdown. So quick, so easy, so efficient. Big, big drive coming up for this UConn offense. They have got to answer this FIU team.
Taquan Roberson is back, started the season opener last year at Utah State. Hurt drive two after a touchdown run. And Logan, torn ACL, lost for the season. Lost the starting job, but Joe Fignano hurt last week at Georgia State. Season-ending shoulder injury and surgery. Houston carries on first down and has about three for UConn. A little more on Taquan Roberson out of New Jersey. He's only played in parts of eight college games, a Penn State transfer, second career start, QB1 again. It's amazing. He won the job last year, hurt in week one at Utah State. And Fignano hurt in week two at Georgia State in Atlanta last week. And Roberson again is the starting quarterback.
Yeah, threw it 30 times last week, so with two touchdowns. So if anything, he's got some confidence.
Dual threat QB. Throwing for the first time. Caught by the tight end, Joey. He's got the grab. He's the most versatile tight end that UConn's got. The T-Mobile lineups here for UConn.
Yeah, and you look at right there, Rick DeRosa. Here's a guy that had 89 yards last year when he played against this defense, two touchdowns. And really, there's a guy that they're going to lean on. There's between him and Devontae Houston, two power backs, and Houston with all that speed. They got to lean on that run game, and right away, a third and short. Let's see if they can move the football.
And big Jelani Stafford, defensive lineman, comes in to help out right behind the quarterback, Roberson. Stafford, the big man, using everything he's got. And it's a first down. T-Mobile FIU defense here, Christian.
A lot of good players. You look at Manuel right there, but DeVarick Daniel, probably pound for pound the toughest guy on this team. I mean, he just sees the game really well. And if they're going to dedicate an extra player to get in that box and stop that run, Daniel is going to be key.
Middle linebacker Donovan Manuel, six in the FBS, almost 13 tackles a game. Watch number 10 at the Mike Backer spot. He's talented. It's a first down for UConn. Rosa. UConn's leading rusher has got about four on the first down carry. Electrifying, had 11 touchdown runs last year, as we check your keys to the game.
Yeah, it's simple. If you go back to last year, just stop the run. They gave up 295 yards last year to UConn, that FIU defense. And a lot of those guys are still on this team. And then for UConn, it's contained Jenkins. So right now, they want to stop him throwing the ball and running the ball. And this defense, so far, has done neither.
Four wide receivers in the game here. Taquan Roberson, who talked this week to us about taking care of the ball, making good decisions in his second career Husky start. Rosa, a cut. Rosa lunges forward and gets to about the 39. Set up a third down. About five here for UConn. Jeremy Pass, more defensive end, has got to play defensively for the Panthers.
One of the things for this FIU defense, they say obviously they want to stop the run. They remember what happened last year, but more importantly, stop the run in between the tackles. Now this UConn offense, they basically run the old school Denver Broncos, Mike Shanahan, Kyle Shanahan stretch offense. So you know they want to hit that edge, but they are really waiting for the cutback. So whoever is in the B gap, that was the guy in between the guard and the tackle, that's who needs to make a big play.
Here's Rosa. Got the hole, got the first down for UConn. Blades makes the tackle from his cornerback spot for FIU. Chains move for the Huskies. Confidence builder early in this game.
Yeah, they needed to. And you saw right there, this is what they're going to do. They're just going to keep sawing wood. They're going to keep pressing that edge. And as soon as one of Rosa or Houston recognizes that they're over-pursuing, they're going to put their foot in the ground. And that's how they get a lot of their big runs. And they need to. So look at the safeties right here. The safeties, they're going to have to play up a little bit more the more they have success in the run game.
Roberson not playing the opener against NC State here. Throws here. Deep ball. Trying there for Jordan Porter. Some contact downfield, but no flag. Remember, Zeke Massis had a pick six last week against Georgia, or rather North Texas, as you see some of the yards per game. Last year, big numbers, yeah. Certainly for the Huskies on the ground.
And Rosa, obviously a true freshman that year, had two touchdowns on top of the 89 yards. And Devontae Houston, big back. I mean, this is the home run ball. Devontae Houston, last year, number 25. This year, changed his number to number one.
They play the drive here for the Huskies. Start their own 21. First possession of the game today. Houston, stretch play left, breaks a tackle. Devontae Houston, first down. Big play offensively for UConn. Jordan Garon, redshirt sophomore from Valrico, Florida, drives him out of bounds. Chains move again for the Huskies.
Free safety, CJ Christian, number four. It almost looks like he has him right there, and he misses him. Devontae Houston just kind of slips him a little bit, and this is the mentality. They couldn't run the ball last week. Only, 25 yards in the first half. Ended the game with 50 yards. They didn't change their scheme. They're not changing their philosophy off one bad game. They said, we're going to stick with what we do, and we're going to force them to deal with it.
And it's 16, and a Husky first down inside the 40. Great speed for Houston. Carries again. Big hole, Devontae Houston. First down and then some. Here's the cut. Eventually run down. A tackle from Jamal Potts, the linebacker of FIU. Touchdown saving play. First down again for the Huskies on the move here.
Yeah, the one thing I like is you watch two things. Rayonte Brown, number 80, is going to outside release. He's not. There he goes. There you go. Outside release, which forces the defensive back to turn his back. He doesn't even see what Houston is doing. And then you have Christian Hayes and Chase Lund, both guys taking their guys and making a big hole for that back.
Run game way down from a year ago for Jim Moore's team. Six wins a season ago, the bowl game. Myrtle Beach Bowl lost to Marshall, but what a turnaround from one win in 21. Now first down, Houston again runs left. Devontae Houston into a pile of white jerseys and shoved. Jack Daly.
Big Jack Daly, number zero.
That's a big dude. I know you love watching him on film.
I do. It's funny. He's like talking to the coaches about big number zero, Jack Daly. Went to Bryant, transferred. He's got about 25 people here to come watch him play. For a big guy, you would think, well, you know, he just kind of stands there and doesn't move. But he moves. Wait, sorry. I undersold it. Probably 100.
100, we heard.
100.
He's from South Glastonbury. That's like 5 miles from the stadium. So hometown here to be sure. Second down. Check with me here for Roberson.
You've had so much success running the football. I wouldn't be surprised if now they try some sort of play action. Second down. You still got your third down waiting for you.
62 rushing yards on the drive. Option look here. Roberson the cut. Lunges ahead. Gets a couple to about the 8.
One thing about this FIU defense, so they're not, especially their linebackers, they're not big guys. Donovan Manuel can close quickly. Reggie Peterson, Jamal Potts, all those guys can close quickly. And they're just trying to work, but they do a great job. They do a great job. Deverick Daniel does a great job catching and staying with the pitch key. And then Robinson has no choice but to kind of eat it and to get as much as he can.
12th play of a very good opening drive for UConn. Here's Houston lined up to the left of Roberson here.
There's your key right there. That's Justin Jolie.
Third and goal. Passing. End zone broken up. Potts was there. No flag. Intended for Ross. And a field goal try coming up here for UConn, Joe McFadden.
Well, it's a tough throw. You're going to go basically a corner route, but it's almost like a go that drifts into a corner route. And he underthrows it. If you're going to hit that, you got to hit this back pylon right there.
McFadden 0 for 1 so far this year. Did not try a field goal against NC State on a Thursday night opener in front of a huge crowd on CBS Sports Network. Missed his only try in Atlanta against Georgia State last week. And hits from 26 for UConn's first points. For those of you watching in our free streaming coverage, it'll conclude after the commercial break. But we'll continue on CBS Sports Network. You can find us by going to cbssportsnetwork.com/channelfinder.
Angel City brings the LA Heat as they aim to continue their hot streak against the Chicago Red Stars on CBS Sports Network.
Meet the future, a chef, a designer, and ooh, an engineer, all learning to save and spend their money with Chase. The chef's cooking up first with her new debit card.
Hungry?
Uh-huh. The designer's eyeing sequins, plaid, while mom is eyeing his spending. Nice. And the engineer? She's taking control with her own account for college. Three futures, all with Chase. Freedom for kids, control for parents, one bank for both. Chase, make more of what's yours.
On season 6 of Fansville by Dr. Pepper, things are heating up.
Mom, Dad, I have a girlfriend, and she likes college football.
The stars have arrived.
I made my choice. This season, I will be drinking
Dr. Pepper strawberries and cream.
And everyone wants a taste of fame.
Welcome back to Chuck's Take, because every fan needs a podcast.
To get a thick color, I use 2 coats of maroon. Don't forget to smash that subscribe button.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
I love your nails.
Thank you.
Why do I choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
So I can keep them all guessing.
So I know their game better than they do.
So I can take my game to the next level.
Because when your bed is this smart, you sleep at the right temperature all night. That's why 80% of NFL players choose the Sleep Number smart bed.
The NFL's best young QBs are on display. Then, a huge showdown in Dallas between the Jets and Cowboys.
Let's go!
We can't wait. The NFL is on CBS and streaming on Paramount Plus.
You're watching college football on CBS Sports Network, presented by the Home Depot. Early fireworks in East Hartford, Connecticut, Rensselaer Field. 7-3 FIU Conference USA leads UConn. Welcome, Dave Ryan, alongside Christian Fourier, two-time Super Bowl champ, tight end star with the Patriots, long NFL career. Keanu Martin on the field in a moment. What a start. 146 total yards of offense. We've seen some fireworks early here, partner.
We've seen everything with FIU, and I think what we expected with UConn, a lot of runs, a lot of outside stretching zone runs.
McFadden, a kickoff here for UConn after his field goal, his first of the season. Roberson in the offense, an effective drive after Jenkins and FIU lit up UConn's defense with a touchdown drive to begin the game. See a lot of points here. FIU coming off a 46-point effort against North Texas last week. Bracey lets that go through for a touchback. Down to Kiana. Tough trip, right, Kiana, for FIU to get here?
Yeah, guys, it's been quite the travel day for FIU. Listen, they dealt with over 8 hours of travel delays, whether it was mechanical or weather. They didn't get into Hartford until just before midnight. A lot of people were concerned about how their performance would be on the field. And, guys, so far, they've been rolling on offense.
Have they ever? And we spoke with Mike McIntyre, pregame warm-ups, head coach of FIU, Christian. He said, look, they're college kids. They'll be all right. They're used to staying up till 2 in the morning, having fun, playing video games, doing homework, you know.
Well,
they'll bounce back. They'll be fine.
They're resilient.
Lawrence feature back here. Jenkins, speaking of young, 18-year-old true freshman. Doesn't turn 19 until November. Throws for Bracey, who's got the catch. Black misses the tackle. And Bracey, little tiptoe down the sideline, picks up some extra yards. First down.
Tackling, Rhino, is going to be so important in this game. You go back to last week, you go back to the game against NC State. When they played NC State, they missed over about 27 tackles. So it's got to be a priority. These guys are slippery, but that is so key for them to shorten the distance, wrap up, and just hold on. Even if they can't bring them down by themselves, just hold on.
Great fake again. Bracey again has the catch. Stan Cross, free safety, makes the play defensively for UConn. First down, though, for FIU. The T-Mobile QB here. The lineups for Jenkins, just 18 years old. Nickname is Lights Out. He got that playing video games as a kid. We had a great chat with him this week. Talk about a confident young man.
he is not afraid of anything. And tell you what, neither of the coaches, they're letting him do pretty much whatever he wants.
Pressure, though, this time, and down he goes. Off the edge, he got nailed. Tui Famina Brown comes in with a hammer sack. Off the edge, loss of 8. Big play on defense for UConn.
Yeah, this is what they're going to need. The one thing UConn has been missing is sacks and turnovers. Let's see if he's – no, he's going to stay in the game. I actually thought he was going to be gimpy a little bit, but he's going to stay in the game, and he's still kind of gingerly walking on that – looks like his right ankle.
Fearless freshman, riverboat gambler-type player. Keijon Owens, his former high school teammate in Miami, is a feature back this time. Chris Mitchell has a catch. Black is there to make the stop defensively. Where you come and gain some of that yardage back. 9 more sets up third down here as we check – the FIU lineup brought to us by T-Mobile.
Yeah, and you can see the FIU. There's Chris Mitchell right there, wide receiver. 297 receiving yards. That almost over 200 in one game, but he's still a go-to guy, third in FBS. He's such a reliable target, and Jenkins and him have really kind of got a nice little connection going early. A lot of trust between those two.
Deep shotgun here for the freshman. Third down. Let's see how the 18-year-old handles the moment here, Christian. Lights out.
Big down for UConn, too, and it looks like they're not going to pressure them. They're just going to play their four down and just let them find the right guy.
Pressure off the edge. Jenkins flushed. Jordan there. Black there first. Noah Black, the Delaware transfer, open field tackle. That's how you do it. And he forces an FIU punt.
And this has got to be so important for them. Quarterbacks have been killing this defense over the last two games. Over almost 200 yards in rushing, one by scrambling and the other last week against North Texas with designed runs. So stopping the quarterback is key, and Jenkins kind of has a little bit of both. You saw the scramble right there, Platt comes up, makes the tackle, and then you saw the earlier designed runs that led to a touchdown.
Dane Montiel Jr. punts here for FIU. Brett Buckman, also a Delaware transfer like Noah Black. On a bounce, got to check up at about the 16. 39-yard punt. That's where UConn back on offense, head-to-head with Mike McIntyre, FIU's head coach.
Papa John's garlic sauce fans, we made the Garlic Epic Stuffed Crust Pizza just for you. With that garlic flavor.
In it, on it, with it.
But you wanted more heat, so now you can get it in spicy. Get a one topping for $13.99, only at Papa John's.
Yo, gotta try this X. It's the fine fragrance. Go.
Trip too hard, don't stand too close. You up on my grind. Off this way, doing all these shows.
X Fine Fragrance Collection. Smell finer than the finest fragrances with the GOAT.
Look like there's a flag.
Mike, I can't keep up with you. You're racing around like you're 10 years younger. How do you stay in such great shape?
Eugenics Total T, Ed, helps me stay leaner, stronger, and gives me back to the energy and stamina I had when I was younger.
How'd you hear about Eugenics?
You kidding? You haven't seen Frank Thomas and Doug Flutie talk about it? Men over 40, get Eugenics Total T and get back on your game.
Tell them to send a text.
Send a text.
To get your complimentary bottle of Eugenics Total T, text
BOLD
to 231231. This unique man-boosting formula is powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically validated to help increase free testosterone levels so you can trim up and stay lean.
Hey, Ralph, aren't you forgetting something?
And you're lucky too.
Get your complimentary bottle of Nugenics now. Text
BOLD
to 231231. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenics Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, absolutely free.
Hold it!
Imagine a world with no drama.
I haven't signed Jody's card yet.
At 4imprint, finding the promotional products you need to create a memorable moment is an easy mission. Our expert team will take care of every detail to make your success a certainty. Take the drama out of ordering promotional products at 4imprint.com.
4imprint, for certain.
College football on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by The Home Depot. How doers get more done. By Ram Trucks. Built to serve. And by Geico. For all your insurance needs, it's easy to Geico.
Both of today's coaches come from football families. George McIntyre, head coach at Vandy. Also, UT Martin from 1979-85 was a National Coach of the Year in 82 at Vanderbilt. Jim Mora, long career in the NFL, most notably head coach of the Saints and the Colts. And Junior, long-time head coach as well. Rosa, his stop. Blades comes up, makes a big play on the speedy running back, Victor Rosa. Loss of two, so second and 12 coming up here for UConn. Great coaching tradition. Jim Mora, head coach for the Falcons and the Seahawks. McIntyre and Jim Mora, Christian, face each other. Your alma mater, the Pac-12, yeah. Colorado, UCLA, and Mora won four of the five games head-to-head.
I think they're both, there's this unique fraternity between these two guys. One, because they're both defensive coaches, and two, they're both coaches' sons that went into the profession. So they know each other, they respect each other. A long history between those two. And they both have a resume of turning programs around.
Rosa can't bring it in. Reggie Peterson was right there step for step trying to belt Rosa if he brought it in. But incomplete, third down and 12. And they can flat coach. These guys have done an incredible job turning programs around. Mike McIntyre, both at San Jose State and Colorado.
Yeah, no, you're right. And they're so intelligent. They both put together a good staff. You know, even when you look at what Mora did, bringing in John Pagano as a special assistant at 26 years as an NFL coaching vet. So they want to make sure that they put a lot of smart individuals and smart people in this coaching room to develop their own players.
Anderson back as a starter, missed an entire year, 10 months of rehab, torn ACL. Third and long, surveys, Blades looks for the pick, breaks it up. And the ball intended for Ross, who himself is coming off a long injury history and foot and leg problems at UConn. It's incomplete. Huskies have to punt.
Yeah, that's a real dangerous throw. Slow to develop. I feel like he could have just either ran it. Watch, there's three guys, and he puts it high. If that ball's tipped the wrong way, that's going into the hands of FIU, and that's going back for a touchdown. I think the key for Roberson, really, you know, in general for this UConn offense, because they don't have a ton of weaponry and they don't have the great ability to throw the football downfield. Just if you don't feel like this guy's open, don't force it.
Jim Mora told us this week our MVP might be George Karatan, the punter. And he said that kind of tongue-in-cheek. Dean Patterson has to really track backwards on his horse to grab it. But that's a possibly a big return for FIU before he's nailed outside the 35. And down he goes.
Yeah, he outkicked his coverage. I mean, it's
nice return for Patterson, one of the star wideouts. 64-yard punt. Maybe he is, in fact, the MVP. Karatan, the punter for UConn.
Roommate to save money, is that the plan?
Well, we gotta find some way to save, so say hi to Glenn from work.
Hey, that's my mom.
I think I have a much better plan. We switched to my plan from Verizon.
We get exactly what we want and save big.
All on the network we can count on.
It's a good plan.
It is a good plan. Glenn, looks like we're not gonna be needing you, so I'll see you at work.
Oh, later, Glenn.
This week, new and current customers get a free Samsung Galaxy S23 plus Galaxy Watch and Tab. All three, all on us. That's a savings of over $1,800. Offer ends soon. It's your Verizon.
Those new tiles are falling right into place until you run out of, what are those called again? Oh, right. The Home Depot app is made for doing that doesn't miss a beat. So you can find what you need fast and keep things moving in the right direction. For doing that doesn't stop, download the Home Depot app. It's made for doing.
Yo, gotta try this X. It's the fine fragrance. Go.
Drip too hard, don't stand too close. You up on the ground. Off this way, doing all these shows.
X Fine Fragrance Collection. Smell finer than the finest fragrances with the goat. Psst, psst.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spray Flonase Sensimist daily for non-drowsy, long-lasting relief in a scent-free, gentle mist. Psst, psst. Flonase, all good. Also, try our allergy, headache, and nighttime pills.
20th year of football here at Rensselaer Field. 69-54 all-time record for UConn in their home building. Tomorrow night, 6 Eastern, get ready for an NWSL thriller as the regular season winds down and Angel City ramps up momentum for a chance at this year's playoffs. Catch all the action here on CBS Sports Network. UConn 5-1 at home last year. A tough loss to NC State to open the home slate this year by 10. Stopping the quarterback has been an issue for the Husky defense 2 weeks in a row. And Jenkins is 5-for-5 so far throwing. Looking for 6-for-6. Time sets up. Big ball brought in. Big catch. And the first down, Bell has the tackle. It's a pickup of 48 yards. Eric Rivers coming off a hand injury has the big play.
Well, he gets great protection, play action pass, but he won this route, Rivers did, by with his release.
Second catch of the year for Rivers. Jacob Peace, right guard, grad student from Miami, is injured for FIU.
A truck is a tool, but a ram is life. It's the let's load up the ATVs life. The my kids play way too many sports life. The let's find a secret spot to fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 4,000 retail consumer cash allowance on most 2023 Ram 1500 trucks. See your Ram dealer today.
At FanDuel, we know how great it is to celebrate a win. And we want everyone to celebrate this NFL season. That's why we're giving away over $1 million in prizes with FanDuel free-to-play games. So lace up those dancing shoes. Because with FanDuel, you can feel like a winner after every play. Make every moment more with FanDuel, official partner of the NFL.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. What's with the sandwich names?
Oh, they're just nods to my time in the Army.
Oh, but what's the Steven named after?
Steven is from Navy Federal Credit Union. They've been helping with my finances since I enlisted. You want another Steven, Steven?
Keep them coming, Hannah.
Okay.
Maybe someday I could get a sandwich named after me. No.
Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission. Psst, psst.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spray Flonase Sensimist daily for non-drowsy, long-lasting relief in a scent-free, gentle mist. Psst, psst. Flonase, all good. Also, try our allergy, headache, and nighttime pills.
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and Allspice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
6'5", grad student Jacob Peace from Miami. Returning starter is in the injury tent for the Panthers currently. Being attended to by FIU trainers. Last play, Christian.
Yeah, and here's Malcolm Bell. Here's Malcolm Bell, the corner right here. He's got inside shade. The one place he can't lose is inside. Rivers beats him off the line, and then you can see the safety. He thinks he's got help. The sideline is his friend, and he just goes right by him. There's no safety help because Bell got beat so quickly off the line of scrimmage. That's an unbelievable move by number 13, Eric Rivers.
Sophomore Plant City, Florida, 6'3", 290. Wyatt Lawson replaces Peace. Play fake again. Jenkins trying to stay perfect, but this time throws away. First incompletion of the game for the 18-year-old freshman they call Lights Out. There is a flag down. We check the UConn defense.
And there's Jackson Mitchell. That is the standard. There's the tackling machine. That's the surest tackler on this team. Last year, had 140 total tackles. Right now, he's averaging 11 tackles per game.
There's no foul on the play for an eligible receiver downfield because the quarterback legally grounded the ball.
So that last play, it was the same exact play they ran in the first series. They ran it twice, that time to Jackson McDonald, the tight end. This time they tried to run the same play, but no, to number 89, Rocky Beers. But it looks like UConn has kind of figured out what they're trying to do.
Keyjohn Owens, Conference USA Offensive Player of the Week, gets the carry. Coming off a 3-touchdown game against North Texas. Russell backwards. Hit there by Rashawn Wilkins up front for UConn. Transfer sophomore from Illinois in the Big Ten. Sets up third down. We'll see how the freshman handles another challenging moment here, Christian.
Yeah, and I can see why they like Owens, because he's just really quick feet in that hole, especially inside the red zone, getting closer to the, you know, to the 10-yard line, making people miss. And you're right about Jenkins. He's been pretty good since the game started. Only one incompletion so far.
Won his last 26 straight games at Miami Central High School, won three straight state titles, won his first two college starts, 28 in a row.
So now watch number 8, Jackson Mitchell right here. He's going to be spying. There he is right there.
Jenkins runs. Stop shy. Palmina Brown has had a really good start to this game defensively for UConn, and Mitchell involved.
And that
now
makes
decision
sense.
Time for Mike McIntyre. Does not hesitate. Christian wants to go for a field goal.
No, and that makes sense. I like the fact that in that last play, they only rushed three. And like, listen, we're going to make sure we have somebody, a sure tackler, to make sure that they are able to
tackle
these shifty backs.
The first quarter.
End of the first quarter. In the second, a field goal attempt coming up here for Chase Gabriel. Jenkins and company, fantastic offensively in the opening quarter from East Hartford.
When you have something to get done today, getting everything you need today is helpful. That's why Ace has free in-store and curbside pickup, or even same-day delivery from your locally owned neighborhood Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Meet the team, behind the team. The coach, the manager, and the snack dad, all using Chase to keep up with their finances. The coach helps save goals here because she saved for soccer camp there. And check this out. The manager deposited a check. Magic. And the snack dad, he's getting paid back. Orange slices. Because this team all has Chase. Smart bankers, convenient tools, one bank with the power of both. Chase, make more of what's yours. Psst, psst.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spraying Flonase daily gives you long-lasting, non-drowsy relief. Psst, psst. Flonase, all good. Also, try our allergy, headache, and nighttime pills.
Hey, Coach, I brought Tostitos.
Why is Micah Parsons here? Whoa.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
We make a great team.
I need a haircut.
Oh, okay.
Can you believe it?
Nice bud hat.
I know, right? How great is that?
Pretty great.
There's nothing better than getting your hair back. So go to Bosley, America's number one hair restoration experts, and the only permanent solution to hair loss that's protected by the Bosley Guarantee. For free info and even a free gift card, scan the code now. You'll see how the latest technology can regrow your real hair and regain your confidence.
Doesn't that hurt?
Sure does.
Don't wait. Get your hair back. Scan the code for free info and a gift card for $250 off. Bosley, the confidence to be you again.
At Grainger, we're for the ones who pay attention to every little detail. The ones who fuss, tinker, and sweat the small stuff. Because you know the tiniest thing can make the biggest difference when it comes to keeping business moving. We get it. We're the same way, offering access to product experts to help you quickly and easily find what you need. So whatever your industry, you know you're always getting professional-grade products. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
BYU on the road, a 7-3 lead, getting set for the start of the second quarter from East Hartford. Down to caught up with Mike McIntyre, FIU's head coach, a moment ago.
Coach, just given the travel issues you guys had yesterday, how do you like how your team's come out so far in the first quarter?
I like them a lot. You know, they're college kids. They stay up late, right? Like we did when we were young. They're a resilient bunch, and they're fighting hard.
What do you want to see more of going into the second quarter and beyond?
I just want to see us keep playing hard and finish these drives and just keep competing.
Thanks so much, Coach.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Got it. Coach Mack, thanks so much. What happened with his freshman, Juwan Jenkins, 6-7, 112 yards. Touchdown run. First drive. Short field goal here for Gabriel. Beginning the second quarter. And he's got it. And the Panthers have three more points. From 27. Gabriel 3-for-3 on the year so far. Three games for FIU, Christian. They played that week zero game at Louisiana Tech. Winnable game. They're ahead until 90 seconds to go. They gave a long TD run. Otherwise, they'd be one of the big stories along with Colorado and Neon Deion playing Colorado State tonight.
Yeah,
everyone's in Denver.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, 3-0 FIU would be a huge story. It's a very good team, though.
Well, listen. They believe they should be 3-0, and look, if you look at that first game, I mean, they were ahead for a big chunk of that first half, and then allowed La Tech to come back up and tie it and then take the lead late in the fourth quarter.
Ryan Domino, new return man here. Ryan Bruton, junior from Miami, who happened to top return man, left the team on Tuesday looking to transfer. He was a third running back for UConn's offense, so he's gone.
Just didn't want to play anymore. So I totally get that.
It happens.
It's just one day you wake up, you say, I don't want to get hit anymore.
Gabriel, deep kick. Touchback, Joe Fagnano, starting quarterback. Game two, Georgia State in Atlanta last week. Christian, shoulder injury on a QB run. Separated his shoulder, surgery required. That happened yesterday. He's out for the year. Tough kid, tough break.
Yeah, tough kid. Transferred from Maine. Nick Charlton was his head coach at Maine. You know, got him in the transfer portal. Wins the starting job. Plays in one game. Gets hurt. You said tough. Like, he stayed in the game. He didn't come out of the game. Mm-hmm. He had an extra two series before he finally just said, listen, I can't throw the football. And that's where Robertson, ironically enough, ends up getting back his starting job that he lost because he got hurt in the first game last year.
Houston and James Burns, the Austin Peay transfer in the backfield here with Roberson to start this drive. Burns, first carry, it's a loss. Alex Nobles, the UNC grad transfer, the pursuit and the hammer tackle for the Panthers, loss of two.
Yeah, number 97, Alex Noble. Former walk-on at North Carolina, was there 3 years, and he's always going to be on the open side of the offense. So all he does is chase this down because he's got so much speed. Great job in pursuit, staying real flat, tackle for a loss on the board.
Burns had that wild play where he and Houston collided in your NC State game. You broadcast, but it was a forward pass. And not a turnover against the Wolfpack. They love his speed, runs more than 20 miles an hour. Houston feature back here. Roberson passes. Catch made for Porter. And a pursuit fantastic for FIU's defense. Donovan Manuel, their star middle linebacker. Six in the FBS, 13 tackles a game. Is there immediately.
Yeah, and he's got closing speed. We talked to those coaches. Lost 12 to 15 pounds from last year. Just wanted to be faster. Now he's making plays like this place out on the edge that the coaches say, listen, he probably wouldn't make that play.
Third down. Coaches said he learned what broccoli was. Learn how to eat some greens. Eat a little better. Training table, right? Got to do that. Take care of yourself.
It's hard in college. You want it easy, fast.
Third down. Roberson delivers. Manuel almost had the pick. It's incomplete. Jolie, the intended receiver. Punt time here for UConn.
This is the rare drop for number 17, Justin Jolie. I've called a bunch of his games. I don't think I've ever seen him drop a catchable pass. That one right there in the breadbasket. They flexed him out. He just couldn't come down with it. And listen, you throw him the ball 100 times, he'll catch 99 of them. So I'm sure he's on the sideline going to his quarterback saying, listen, I got you next time. Don't worry about it. It won't happen again.
Garitan, freshman. Arkansas transfer. Punts here to Patterson. Nice kick. Dean Patterson from the 35. Elusive. Breaks a tackle. Breaks two. Plus territory. And good field position. On a 21-yard return. Rosa tackles special teams, but FIU set up well with their electrifying young quarterback, Kewan Jenkins. He's only 18 years old, the true freshman of Miami.
I do the impossible, impossible.
Old Trapper Beefs, camping catastrophes.
So the kids want to go camping again.
Well?
Hi,
Yeah, let's go camping.
Yay! Old Trapper, what's your beef?
You know, they say, losing hope, that's the real disaster. Last year, Tropical Storm Fred sent a devastating wall of water and debris down this river. And when the waters receded, Belfour was here. Not just to rebuild, but to help restore the life of this community. Belfour, restoring more than property.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spraying Flonase daily gives you long-lasting, non-drowsy relief. Flonase, all good. Also, try our allergy headache and nighttime pills.
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and Old Spice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
Papa John's garlic sauce fans, we made the Garlic Epic Stuffed Crust Pizza just for you. With that garlic flavor.
In it, on it, with it.
But you wanted more heat, so now you can get it in spicy. Get a one topping for $13.99 only at Papa John's.
Second ever meeting between FIU and UConn last year. An easy win down in Miami for UConn. First ever in East Hartford. Juwan Jenkins has been something else. We had a nice chat with him, Christian, this week. He said, my favorite player growing up, Cam Newton, except I'm more elusive than Cam was.
Wow, and a lot smaller. I'll tell you what, I mean, Cam Newton, as big as he is, as strong as he is, that's a good guy to emulate, I guess, if you want to do everything, because Cam Newton can run it, he can throw it. But I would say that Jenkins probably is going to run around people, not through them.
Our Sonic QB comparison, we saw the stats between the two. The young freshman back on the field. Hands there for Lawrence. Who has the first hit against Shamari Lawrence. Team's leading rusher, 254 yards. And a long touchdown run against Louisiana Tech in Ruston, week zero. Third play from scrimmage when Grayson James is starting quarterback for FIU. Lawrence again drives the pile forward, and he's shy by about a yard. McCarthy makes the stop back down to Kiana.
Hey guys, so I have my eyes on Jacob Hees, who spent quite a bit of time in the tent. They were working on his right knee. He was in the tent. Once he got out, he got on the bike. Now he's working on pass blocking drills on the sideline. He has his helmet on, so it looks like he's going to try to give it a go, you guys.
It's good news. Thanks, Kiana, for FIU. David Yost, offensive corner, said that side of the line has been really good.
Here we go.
Look at the setup. We saw this for the touchdown. Jenkins hands it off this time. Lawrence breaks a tackle. Flag flies. Noah Black makes the play defensive. Let's check out the marker. It could be a hole here against FIU. There's a first down. And it's coming back.
Holding. Offense. Number 10. 10-yard penalty. Third down.
That's their star receiver, Chris Mitchell.
Yeah, that's a huge loss right there. Let's see if we can pick it up. So, number 10, I don't know if that's a hold. I think the defender just fell down. If you watch, there he goes, number 10 right there. And listen, not a fan of the call at all. I think they're going to throw that into the officiating crew and tell them to go look at that one again. And now this is where you want. Now it'll be key to see how they attack them. You know Jenkins can run. Someone has to be responsible for number one. Keon lights out Jenkins, because if it's not there, he's getting out of there. And here's the guy that's going to get him, number eight right here, Jackson Mitchell. He's right over the center.
Panthers,
there he is right there.
Yep, first third down conversion. Jenkins thinking about running it. Then he's going to throw it. Hollamo, perfect delivery. It's a touchdown for Jalen Bracey at FIU. Gunslinger on the money to Bracey. Another score for the Panthers, 45 yards of perfection for the visitors from Miami.
I don't know how Bracey ends up getting behind the entire defense, but he gets behind three defenders. They all run. They only rush four. They drop seven. They're just playing zone. And we talk about finding the open window. That's what the coaches talked about. That's what they said was one of his strong assets, is anticipating guys coming open and throwing it to them before they're open, letting them just run and catch it. And that's exactly what they did.
PAT, Chase Gabriel. Bracy, first touchdown catch of the year. Jalen Bracy, the connection with Kiwan Jenkins. How about that lefty throw?
A little Michael Vick, maybe.
There you go.
Sweet for FIU.
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and Old Spice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one breath. But you can recover like me. Always. Every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
Hello, welcome to T-Town. Like men over 40 everywhere, these guys experience a drop in testosterone. Don't worry, it happens to all of us. Some guys took my advice about how to boost their testosterone, and some didn't. This guy got the message loud and clear.
That's right, Nugenix Total T.
Nugenix Total T is the unique patented formula powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to boost free testosterone to help you feel stronger, leaner, with more muscle and drive. Nugenix is number one doctor recommended, number one at GNC, and number one at Walmart. But you can only get your complimentary bottle by texting RIGHT to 42424.
Thanks.
It'll make you feel like a new man. And by the way, she'll like it too.
Get your complimentary bottle of Nugenix now. Text RIGHT to 42424. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo X, our newest, most powerful fat incinerator ever, absolutely free. Go! Go!
You got me.
Tag, you're it.
Imagine a world with no drama. With 4imprint, you don't have to chase down the perfect promotional products. Exclusive apparel, bags, drinkware, and more. 4imprint will help you capture the moment and guarantee to deliver your order on time and on budget. Take the drama out of ordering promotional products at 4imprint.com.
4imprint, for certain.
So when you look at how this play works and how Bracy gets so wide open, you look at the all 22 copy and watch right here, number two, Durante Jones. And here, right here, he's just gonna run all the way across. But what Durante does is he sees this receiver stop and he jumps the receiver, which allows this ginormous hole right here. And of course, Jenkins buys himself some time, hits him in stride, and he's wide open. Poor communication, overzealous, a little over-aggressive by the defensive back, not worrying about the deep crosser. That's how we got so wide open, and that's how Jenkins was able to hit him again in stride.
Diaz is the kickoff man for FIU. Domino on the receiving end. We'll bring it out for UConn. Up-handed cut down, still on his feet. Pyle pushed around, forward for a second, then stops at about the 24, and that's where UConn takes over. First and 10.
Wow. Three plays.
Wow. Quick. What a throwing arm for Jenkins. I told us this week, Western Carolina wanted him as a quarterback.
Yep.
Auburn came in, new coach Hugh Freeze, very late in the process, but said, look, it's going to be at least 3 years till you play. He wanted to play right away. How did he not win the job out of camp? Number two to Grayson James. He's number one now.
Well, I mean, he was really honest with us over the week. He said, listen, he had about 5 days where he just did not have good practices. And then James kind of overtook him. And he said the reason why, because his girlfriend left and he was sad. He was a little bummed out that she left.
He was bummed out. Well, he recovered clearly. Roberson, the play fake. Ross, the catch. Nice grab. Zeke Massis had the pick six against North Texas last week on the coverage.
Yeah, I like this play. I like the way they run this play. He's got Jolie open, but Cam Ross, who they need to get going a little bit more, jumps up high, points the ball. They need to get Cam Ross back involved. They need to get Buckman back involved, who had 9 catches so far. Buckman, number 10, hasn't had 1 reception.
No targets, no catches for Buckman. Had a TD catch at Georgia State last week. Spectacular one-handed grab. On first down, Rosa. Fastest Husky runs in a lot of trouble. Down he goes. Wow.
Good job by that defensive line.
Jordan Garrod was right there, partner, and that was a thump.
Yeah, they're just going to slide with it, stay in their lane, and then Bapp just make sure there's no open lanes for him to run. Lance Hill, number 95.
All over. Boost out up front so far. McIntyre, defensive-minded coach. No gain, second and 10 for Roberson. Ross swings behind in motion. Here comes some pressure. That ball was deflected, or at least altered. Great heat from Nobles, who got there right away. There's no whistle. Was there a whistle? Hang on a minute. Is that a fumble or an incomplete pass? Let's examine here. Manuel grabbed it for FIU because the Panthers didn't hear a whistle. And are hoping they've turned it over.
The ruling on the field is an incomplete pass.
All right.
Third down.
Let's take a look here.
Well, this is Alex Nobles, number 97, is going to come to them from the right side of the screen, and he just loops. It's just a stunt right there. There he goes right there, and he looks like he hits him right before he throws it. Lucky for everybody, well, especially on the UConn side, that ball hit the dirt. So far, the one thing that this UConn offensive line is having trouble with is movement by the front four. FIU likes to blitz from depth. They're going to try to find ways to get number two, Avery Huff, in some sort of mismatch. Number 97, Alex Nobles, who is your rush end.
Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 10 minutes and 23 seconds, please.
As we all know, first Thank downs you. Now. The clock does not stop at college football. Just inside 2 minutes, second and fourth quarters. I know you'd like the rule, Christian. I
love
your opinion on that. Faster games.
So
20-some minutes faster.
This is my key right here. Look at the safety where he's at. If this is their best receiver, Jolie dropped the ball earlier.
Third down, Roberson. Here comes some pressure. Evades the heat, and then out of bounds he goes.
He had him open. He had him open, and then when he tried to scramble, he had him open again, but he held onto the ball just a little bit too long. Gave the safety some time to recover and man up. Number 17, Justin Jolie.
Elijah Anderson Taylor, the Northern Colorado FCS transfer, bumps him out of bounds. Good heat there from Garrod.
You can see he wants him right there, but he just doesn't want to throw a pick because number 12, Zeke Masses, is right there just waiting for him to make a mistake.
Garrod 10 averaged 40 yards a kick last year. 58-yard career best against NC State in the opener. It really has been good. Patterson. On the return, dances out of bounds at about the 20, 38-yard punt for Caratan. Punter of UConn, Jim Moore's team in a two-score hole in East Hartford.
A truck is a tool, but a Ram is life. It's the Let's Load Up the ATVs life. The My Kids Play Way Too Many Sports life. The Let's Find a Secret Spot to Fish life. Nice. Discover how Ram powers all the lives you live during Ram Power Days.
During Ram Power Days, get 4,000 retail consumer cash allowance on most 2023 Ram 1500 trucks. See your Ram dealer today.
The Jersey Mike's catering box is the easiest way to feed your friends. The hard part is picking your sub. That's why we're having a draft. With the first pick, Sarah from Carolina selects number 13, the original Italian.
You know, I trusted my gut, and that's exactly where the sub's gonna go, so.
Hold on, we've got a trade. Jake traded his second pick with me, because I'm starved.
Freshly sliced subs to go, wherever you and your friends go. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
Yeah.
Bringing in a new roommate to save money, is that the plan?
Well, we gotta find some way to save, so say hi to Glenn from work.
Hey. That's my mom.
I think I have a much better plan. We switched to my plan from Verizon.
We get exactly what we want and save big.
All on the network we can count on.
It's a good plan.
It is a good plan. Glenn, looks like we're not going to be needing you. So I'll see you at work.
Oh, later, Glenn.
This week, new and current customers get a free Samsung Galaxy S23 plus Galaxy Watch and Tab. All three, all on us. That's a savings of over $1,800. Offer ends soon. It's your Verizon.
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and Allspice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me. Almonds. Every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
FIU's game against North Texas last week, dubbed Hispanic Heritage Kickoff. Prior to the game, FIU unveiled the Vamos Pamperas mural. School's athletic department worked with first-generation Cuban-American and Miami native Ivan Roque to create this marvelous piece of art located inside FIU Stadium. That is terrific. Very well done. CBS Sports celebrates Hispanic Heritage Month. FIU celebrating an early lead here, head-to-head with UConn after the rough travel Kiana told us about last night. First down, throw for Mitchell. That's beyond the reach, second incompletion of the game. And the young freshman, Kewan Jenkins, first true freshman to start at QB for FIU Partners since Alex Magoo in 2014 against North Texas. This kid is something.
Yeah, and I know what I like about it is, like, right there, he was throwing to Dean Patterson, number 11. There's no hitch in anything he's doing. He's just catching the football. He's trusting his eyes, and he's throwing it. That time, number 7, Chris Sharon, actually held Patterson on that play. And if it wasn't thrown out of bounds, it probably would have been a holding.
Drops the snap. And just got a fall on it. Instead of third and very long here, all the way back to the 15. So a loss of 5 on that play for Jenkins.
Yeah, just one of those deals where you just watch his eyes right there. He just looks like it's not a great snap, first of all. It's a little bit to his left, then he takes his eyes off it slightly. Now, if you pay attention to what UConn does right now, obviously, they're going to keep 3 defensive linemen in the game and then make sure they have number 95, Eric Watts, as the rush end. And this has been a problem. Third and long, lots of space.
Four receivers, one back. Handoff. Owens. Nothing doing. Jelani Stafford got there immediately. And a junior from Brownsville, Pennsylvania, creates a loss of 2. TFL punt time, FIU.
Yeah, beats 2 blockers too to make the tackle for a loss. Great effort move by the big number 97, Jelani Stafford. They needed that too. UConn needed to have a quick 3 and out. So they fumble the snap on second down, FIU does, and they have a great job getting a tackle for a loss, and they should get decent field position.
Montiel, redshirt junior, Pompano Beach, Florida, transfer from Marshall. Punt stands just outside his goal line to Buckman. UConn can really use good field position here. And over end kick. Here's Buckman. Had 2 drops last week. Makes a fair catch on the 40-yard punt from Dayton Montiel. Is a flag down. Let's check out our call. Art Brown, our referee today from Newark, Delaware. The hybrid crew involved with some ACC officials today.
And I'm sure they all know what they want to call. Right to the middle of the field.
During the kick, holding receiving team number 12. That 10-yard penalty is enforced on the end of the kick. First down.
Another bad mistake for UConn.
Yeah.
That hurts. Well, the defense been great today.
Yeah, it has, and they're doing a good job. You know, stopping the run was key. So they're doing a good job doing that. Not many big runs early in the first series they did, but they've done a good job of really keeping these backs in check and then really making sure Robertson has nowhere to go with the ball. Sacked him a couple times, rushed him out of the pocket a couple times.
85 total yards for UConn so far. Huskies have been shut out in every game so far in the second quarter. Very good. Last defense today. Not entry play for FIU. Panthers last of 9 teams in this year's version of Conference USA. Kennesaw State joins the league next year for 10. Houston feature back off the penalty, backing them up 10. Goes down for UConn. Devontae Houston. Got good speed. CJ Christian first to get to him. Contact from the safety spot. Should have had 2 picks last week. And 1 interception early against North Texas. And then 1 call back because of a targeting call. There was a pick fest going on last week.
There was a Miami. Lot going on, yeah. Either guy's number 12, Zeke Massa. He's had his first career interception last week.
Pick 6.
Yeah, ran it back for a touchdown.
Wild
Not bad.
Game. 46-39. FIU Partners played in 3 straight one-score games. They've been tight ones. Could be 3-0, 2-1 coming in. Overset for Houston. Makes his cut. That's by Prendergast. And Peterson makes the stop defensively for FIU. Sets up third down for UConn.
Yeah, and what FIU is doing, they're really just almost giving, conceding to the run. They keep having two safeties back and not an extra man in the box to stop the run. And they're doing a pretty good job so far without extra help. I thought that they would have to devote extra men up closer to the line of scrimmage to make sure they took care of that zone stretch play. And so far, they're doing a really good job with it.
Huskies could really use a conversion here on third down. Houston motion man. Quick release, Buckman behind him, it's incomplete. Zeke Massis on coverage, corner for FIU, and the Huskies again have got a punt here.
We mentioned Buckman, and he's got a beat. This is a back shoulder throw. It's just a little too high and a little too outside for Buckman to come down and make a catch on it. And Buckman, usually you get it anywhere in his vicinity, he's going to bring it down. Right now, Roberson a little erratic with some of his passes right now. He's going to have to tighten it up if these guys are going to have a shot to keep up with this FIU offense.
Fourth straight punt. UConn offense sputtering after a really nice start. That's a field goal from Joe McFadden. Carrington again. Patterson again, it's out of bounds. Let's see where that spot is. To the 25. FIU back on offense against Jim Moore's defense.
Meet the future. A chef, a designer, and ooh, an engineer. All learning to save and spend their money with Chase. The chef's cooking up first with her new debit card.
Hungry?
Uh-huh. The designer's eyeing sequins, no, plaid. While mom is eyeing his spending. Nice. And the engineer? She's taking control with her own account for college. Three futures, all with Chase. Freedom for kids, control for parents, one bank for both. Chase, make more of what's yours.
Camp! Camp! How'd you spend the off-season?
The off-season?
Little Caesars tastes so good.
It tastes even better with my best friends.
Three best friends eating pizza all the time. Having fun. Pizza, pizza, pounds for life.
The off season? Just hit the weights.
Try the new four-quarter calzone from Little Caesars for $8.99. It's officially delicious.
Pizza, pizza.
Huh. How long have you been tracking our car's value with Carvana?
Just like 7 months.
Should we sell it?
We hold.
Hold.
Silver vans are going for more right now. Should we?
Hold. Our low mileage is paying off. You think we should?
Hold.
Depreciation's really heating up. You think?
Hold. We just did 2.5%.
Hold. Now.
I'm on it.
Already sold to Carvana.
Go to Carvana and track your car's value today.
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advance and Allspice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me. Almonds, every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
Coming up on the Ram Trucks Halftime Report, Brent Stover, Kevin Carter, Danny Canal will break down this game, get you caught up in the games around the country. It's all coming up on the Ram Trucks Halftime Report. So to open out the AP Top 10 powered by Ram Trucks. Florida State, a lot of people picking them, Christian, to be a playoff-type team. Had a battle not too far from here against BC. And on CBS, two-time defending champ, Georgia struggling with South Carolina.
Yeah, you know, and BC, you look at that Florida State going up there, you know, every now and then you just wake up and whether your plane is delayed or not, you don't play your best game. And, you know, BC trying to get some wins, had a close win to Holy Cross last week. And, yeah, Georgia with South Carolina, it's early though.
Long way to go in that one. Alabama, could they lose a second straight? First down run yields maybe a yard for FIU. Here there from Shamar Lawrence. Mitchell has the stop. The game summary so far. Look at the total yards for the young fresh running this offense. Jenkins been fabulous.
Yeah, they've been great. Everything they dial up works. So right now it's It's all about that right there, and especially that 3.6 yards per carry.
Owens on the last carry. 101 yards, three touchdowns. Team lead through three games for Owens last week. It was fabulous. A shift here, a throw here is low. Mitchell has the catch. Incomplete.
It's low and outside, just kind of where you need it. And it's just a slant route. Jenkins, quick release, sets his feet. Close call. You would think a guy like Mitchell would come down with that one, but that's not a terrible throw, especially where Plack is number 22, ready to give him a good hit if he does catch it.
Two touchdowns for Mitchell against Maine week two. Their career bests. Gracie the TD catch today. Big third down. 18-year-old gunslinger delivers another perfect ball. It's a first down at the 40. Gracie has the catch, slides, and the chains move, gain of 13.
That was a great route by number 14, Jalen Gracie. Last year, had 9 receptions in this game, so I think he kind of probably feels pretty confident about going against this UConn defense.
Flag flies. John Owens, the carry, stretch play left. Let's check out the marker here from our referee, Art Brown. With 5 to go in the first half, it's been all FIU so far.
Holding, offense, number 50. 10-yard penalty, enforcement spotted foul. First down.
Retro freshman, 320-pounder, Nair Jackson, Christian, guilty party.
Yeah, and Delmont Gordine, number 96, he called it right away. As soon as the play was over, he's sitting there pointing to the opposite direction, saying, oh, he's not even worried about getting back to the huddle because he knows what the call is going to be.
He knew. First and 20, backs up the Panthers. Owens has the catch. Bryce Yates has him lined up, shoves him out of bounds. Back down to Kiana.
Hey guys, so Jenkins may be a true freshman, but a word that's become synonymous with him is confidence. Every player, every coach uses it to describe him. Coach McIntyre said it's like he's never seen a bad day, but it's not cocky. We asked him this week what concerns him about facing UConn. His response was simply nothing. He trusted himself and the game isn't too big for him, despite being just 18 years old.
Young guy, no doubt. County's handled it well so far. QB run here, there's Yates, who reads it and drops the freshman. A loss of 3. FIU sputters on this drive.
Yeah, that was a great job, but he doesn't even get he's laid off the ball, actually, like play action away. He keeps it, and there's Yates right there in the right spot. Big, big tackle right there. Now it's 3rd and 20. And now here's what they're going to do. Here's what UConn's going to do. They're just going to keep 3 defensive linemen, and you know, not including number 95, and they're going to drop 8 into coverage. Just let's see if Jenkins can find him.
Keyshawn Owens, former teammate of Kewan Jenkins at Miami Central. Featured back here on 3rd and long. Owens will run it. Former Rocket to former Rocket. And a stop from Mina Brown. A Sam Strong side linebacker. Easy tackle, easy stop for UConn's defense. Punt time for the Panthers. 3:30 and counting. In our first half, and the Huskies a full complement of 3 timeouts.
Yeah, and they needed that big time, right? So they had the holding penalty, they had the fumbled snap on the last series. So UConn defense so far being the beneficiary of some sloppy football right now by FIU, who other than those two series, these last two series, have played a real clean football game.
Montiel punts to Buckman. Some pressure. Date Montiel, a flag down. Buckman grabs it, looks for room up the middle, and wrestled down by CJ Christian among many Panther special teams punt coverage tacklers. 40-yard punt, 13-yard return. Let's check out the flag here. Buckman can be electrifying it. Got to get him going in this game today.
Dorian kick, holding, receiving team number 3. That 10-yard penalty is enforced from the end of the kick. First down.
Again, special teams trouble for UConn. Backs about 10. Tomorrow, we can't wait for another NFL on CBS doubleheader. The early games headlined by the Chiefs-Jaguars. The Raiders take on the Bills. And it's a showdown in Dallas when the Jets hit the road against Dak and the stellar Cowboy defense coming off the 40-zip shutout of the Giants. That was amazing. NFL on CBS streaming on Paramount Plus as well. Some big headlines, Christian, in the NFL this week.
Oh, yeah. The whole 40 to nothing actually stands out to me. I'm like, man, is that even possible for a professional football team to get skunked by 40 points? I would say yes. I was a part of a couple teams in my 13-year career where we took a L the hard way and didn't really realize what the hell has happened until the game was over. But that's why they're pros, and you expect them to bounce back.
A lot of big storylines. See what Zach Wilson does, taking over the Jets. Devontae Houston takes over on first down. Nice cut. Goes by Christian. Another cut. Daniel finally there. Deverick Daniel has the tackle, but all the way out to the 35-yard line. Gain of 19. Chain mover for UConn.
Yeah, and this is Christian Hayes and Yukari Walker. Both guys getting good blocks on their guys. You see them both pulling, trying to get Big Jack Daly, number zero, gets caught up. And then Houston does the rest. You get him in the open field. He's really dangerous. Hard to catch, really, because he's so fast.
Watch the hitting first down pickup. Clock ticks. Orbison throws. First down to Buckman. Beyond his reach, incomplete. And Zeke Massis on coverage. The corner for FIU.
So yeah, and this is the problem, is that they just, you know, either they're open and Roberson can't get it to him, or he's got time to throw and he gets pressured or he gets sacked. When he has open receivers, he's got to hit them. Right. Buckman, it wasn't super tight coverage, but he had enough space for him to catch that ball and fall out of bounds.
Only three completions for Roberson in this first half. Been rough. It was 19-30 against Georgia State, taking over for the starter last week. Devontae Houston stood up, maybe got to the line of scrimmage. Nothing doing there. C.J. Christian, big stop safety spot for the guys from the 305 FIU in Miami. Defense has been really good. 2 minutes to go in the second quarter.
Yeah, the one thing they love about C.J. Christian is the fact that he can cover and he can also feel the alley, and this is what he does, right? Great form tackling by number four. Listed as a free safety, but they'll put him up there tight to the line of scrimmage because he's such a good tackler.
Game for Houston so far today. Kind of wants to get to the 35-yard line, the target line for Joe McFadden. Jim Mora told us this week for a 52-yard range potentially. Waiting moments of the half. Third down. Roberson flushed again. Lots of pressure. Flag flies. Roberson on the move. Buckman can't bring it in at the 44. It's incomplete. There's a flag down on the backfield. Almost certainly a hold. Maybe. The second flag is dropped too. Two indicating the hold. It'll be declined.
Holding. Offense. Number 71. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Valentin Sen. Richard Jr. from Austria.
Yeah, transfer out of Colorado. And the problem with UConn is obviously they're having trouble moving the football, but they are not doing themselves any favors. Back-to-back punts where they've had a holding call, where they had decent field position that pushed them back 10 yards. Obviously, now you have a third and long, and you have another holding call. They're just really making things really difficult for themselves.
Ready for some German? Er kommt aus dem Österreich. It means he comes from Austria.
Oh.
For Valentine's Day. It was my minor at Syracuse, what can I tell you? Patterson on the return. And he's dropped at the 21. 6-yard return for Dean Patterson. Good kick again. Jackson Mitchell on the tackle defensively.
So when you're taking all those communication classes Syracuse, they say, right, hey, we want you to take a minor in some other language, and you chose German?
It was. I just like the language, what can I tell you? And Jim Moore has a player from Switzerland and from Austria and from Germany. Amazing. On one roster. Key to the offense this season, this guy's been really special.
He has, and obviously you can see where obviously everything runs through him. He's so skilled at running the football, throwing the football. There's really nothing he can't do. Only one mishap earlier today, but other than that, he's been really good.
Plus here on first down, dangerous throw sideline, but Neiman's got it. The tight end transfer from Iowa. Black on coverage, almost picked. Gain of 8.
That was a great throw. Okay, this is just an out route. And watch how close he is to getting out of bounds. Gets his 1 foot inbounds. That was an unbelievable throw, and that was a great catch, too. Just, I thought that these tight ends should be more involved. They're great blockers, and with that, you would think they would get some extra opportunities to catch some passes, and Jenkins right now is getting them involved.
Panthers all three timeouts. Keith Jenkins, Yates, and Mitchell catch up with him, but not until he gets a first down. He's past the 35. Clock stops now inside 2 minutes. The new rule with first downs in college football. Nice pickup for the freshman.
Yeah, they just got UConn. They got their head spinning on defense right now. They don't know which way is up. You know, they're throwing the ball well. They're throwing it quick. You know, even though they think they got it, the ball's out of Jenkins' hands so fast. And next you know, you catch your breath, and then he's running it up the middle.
First down. Clock ticks. First half. Jenkins, deep ball. There's Mitchell. Who's got it? Chris Mitchell. Touchdown, FIU. What a throw, what a grab. Panthers score again, 63 yards.
Now, you can see number three, Brinson, is just gonna, he's gonna run right by him, and that's Chris Mitchell. Big ball, big threat guy, big deep ball, and if you go back and even just watch Jenkins catch it, there was no doubt where he was going with the ball. Chris Mitchell was going to run by him, and that was all he was going to do. There was no indecision. There's no doubt. And as soon as he identified who was covering, he let the ball go, and Mitchell underneath it catches it.
Three plays, 25 seconds, 80 yards, lights out. Has been fabulous so far today. We're back in 30 seconds to East Hartford.
Meet the team behind the team. The coach, the manager, and the snack dad, all using Chase to keep up with their finances. The coach helps save goals here because she saved for soccer camp there. And check this out. The manager deposited a check. Magic. And the snack dad, he's getting paid back. Orange slices. Because this team all has Chase. Smart bankers, convenient tools, one bank with the power of both. Chase, make more of what's yours.
All right, so as you see right here, here's number 10. Here's number 10, Chris Mitchell. And all he does is just run a go. And if you watch the safety, number two, Durante Jones, he tries to get there. He can't get there enough. And then he just runs by, let it go. He just runs by number three, Damon Brinson, redshirt junior. And that is all. It gives him a little dead leg right at the top, right by the 50. And then he just runs past him. And then number two, the safety, can't get there in time. And I feel like this defense, I think they're not respecting, one, the speed of those wide receivers, and they're not respecting the fact that Jenkins can throw it easily 50 yards in the air.
Domino, the freshman, run back, UConn. It's one tackler miss before it gets belted. Nice return.
They can't play cover two. They can't play cover three. They're going to need to play cover two. Every outside receiver, they're going to have to give some sort of safety help. The problem is, when they end up doing that, is they just start running the football.
Quick scoring drive. No concern about the end of the first half there for Mike McIntyre. The
no.
Team arrived past midnight with all kinds of mechanical and weather delays coming out of Miami. Had to divert to Orlando, switch planes. No worries.
They're resilient.
They're a young man. It's fine. Roberson, the offense. Buckman has the catch.
So last week, when Roberson went back in the game, he had a bunch of yardage throwing the football. Threw it 30 times, the most he's ever thrown it in a football game. And a big, big guy that he was thrown to was number 10, who had 9 catches last week. But again, they're playing softer coverage. They're going empty. They're allowing him to throw the football.
34 seconds, partner left in the half. Boy, the Huskies would love to get in the range of McFadden to try a field goal here. Roberson, here comes some pressure. Lots of heat. Manuel spies him, and then the throw to Joey's out of bounds and incomplete. Bob Emanuel was hunting there. in his crosshairs.
I tell you what, and one, the problem with Roberson is that, you know, when he escapes, he's just going the wrong way. It's like he's getting running farther back. You watch it right here when the pocket collapses, and he's going to go outside deeper, and he almost gets caught right there. And then he tries to make something happen, and that's where I feel like he's going to get himself in trouble. And right now, it's 3rd and 1, 26 seconds left. Just get the first down. Wouldn't be surprised if he hands it off to Rose or just runs it himself.
Rosa runs right, first down for UConn, makes a nice cut. C.J. Christian has to stop defensively. Clock stops here, 19 seconds, gain of 10 for Rosa. Timeout for UConn.
First charge timeout.
We've got two left here, trying to get in the range of Joe McFadden. 30 seconds. Jim Morris said could be good, stretched out from 52. Next week, Duke UConn coming your way on CBS Sports Network. Duke number 21 in the nation, off to a great start. 3:30 Eastern, Duke plays Northwestern, all academic bowl.
Oh,
today,
there you
going
go.
For their perfect 3-0 start, knocked off Clemson. First win against the top 10 since 1989. Now the first time they're ranked since 2018. Great start for the Blue Devils this year. Not just about basketball in Durham, right?
Yeah. So, you know, as you call it, the academic bowl, right? Everybody get your number two pencils, sharpen them up real quick, get your pocket protectors. Everybody get ready. There's going to be an exam. Everything's going to be on the test. And if UConn is worried about running quarterbacks, Riley Leonard for Duke, oh, no. That guy. You see what he did to Clemson, the way he's running the football?
They took it to Clemson. And Durham trying to get in the range of McFadden. Need about 20 more yards for the Huskies. 19 seconds and two timeouts for Roberson.
Usually they're going to show FIU showing blitz. Usually when a team does that, they usually bail. There they go.
Penn State transfer. Here comes some pressure. Down he goes. Jeremy Passmore, the Indiana transfer, was there. And he smothers Roberson for a big sack in the final seconds of the half. Loss of 9.
He's just got to get rid of the football. He won't let go of the football. He's thinking way too much.
That is the end.
And some boobirds being heard here at Rensselaer Field. Disappointing first half for the home team.
Yeah.
FIU from Miami rolling through 30. End of the first half. After the break, Brent Stover and the crew in New York get you up to everything happening on a busy day in college football. All Panthers and T1 Jenkins, the 18-year-old freshman. Spectacular! You're watching UConn Football on CBS Sports Network, presented by the Home Depot.
Yo, gotta try this X. It's the fine fragrance. Go.
Chip too hard, don't stand too close. You up on my grind. Out this way, doing all these shows.
X Fine Fragrance Collection. Smell finer than the finest fragrances with the GOAT.
Hey, coach, I brought Tostitos.
Why is Micah Parsons here?
Team, war room now.
Whoa.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
Let's go. I need more urgency, coach. So when is everyone coming?
The party is until next week.
We make a great team.
Biggest thing I've learned so far? Don't sweat the small stuff. No. Found it. Finding my light. No, knowing my cue. Just trying not to overthink things. M&M's for all fun kind.
Meet the team, all using Chase to keep up with their finances. Smart bankers, convenient tools, boom. One bank with the power of both. Chase, make more of what's yours.
Guys, got hair loss? I know what you're thinking. Should I shave my head, comb it over, wear a hat? Just stop. This isn't 1970. Keep your hair and your confidence because Bosley, America's number one hair restoration experts, can give you your real hair back permanently. Check them out because they're giving away an absolutely free information kit and a free gift card to everyone who scans this QR code. Dude, you don't have to look like your dad because this isn't your dad's hair loss treatment. People all over the country trust Bosley because they're ahead of the curve. They use the latest technology to give you your real hair back. And the best part, Bosley's permanent solution is protected by the Bosley Guarantee. Let them show you for free how awesome your hair could look with an absolutely free information kit and a gift card for $250 off. Scan the QR code. Don't wait. Scan the code now and ask about the Bosley Guarantee.
At Grainger, we're for the ones who pay attention to every little detail. The ones who fuss, tinker, and sweat the small stuff. Because you know the tiniest thing can make the biggest difference when it comes to keeping business moving. We get it. We're the same way. offering access to product experts to help you quickly and easily find what you need. So whatever your industry, you know you're always getting professional-grade products. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
You are watching the Ram Trucks Halftime Report on CBS Sports Network.
Welcome into the Ram Halftime Report at the break. FIU and UConn, Brent Stover alongside a couple of Sunshine State legends, Danny Cannell, Kevin Carter as well. Kev, what were you chomping on in that first half of a 24-3 game?
Nearly 300 yards of total offense for the FIU Panthers in the first half, 240 of it coming in the air. Quarterback Kiwon is balling in this first half. Look at what he is getting done, okay? He was 9 of 14. No, 11 of 14 for 240 yards, two touchdowns. Kiwon Jenkins has been just incredible. Patient in the pocket, finding open receivers. Not much of a pass rush from UConn at this point, but he has been spectacular and masterful thus far in the first half.
Defense very good as well. It's a 3-touchdown lead on the road for FIU, second half to come. Across the hall, it's the season premiere of the SEC on CBS with South Carolina between the hedges to face the national champs who are looking to win their 20th straight game, and it's been tough sledding so far. What an opening drive for Spencer Rattler. 8 of 8 on the first drive, hit 5 different receivers.
Yeah, this one goes from a screen to Antoine Wells. He weaves his way all the way to the end zone. Gamecocks with a 7-0 lead. Second quarter, DeCarrion Joyner on the Wildcat powers his way in. Gamecocks with a 14-3 lead.
How about that?
First quarter touchdown on Georgia's defense since last year against Georgia Tech. Only 3 in the first quarter, including this one, since 2020.
Do you guys remember last night inside college football? Do you remember what percent chance I gave South Carolina to win this game?
Less than 0.
Zero. And they are shocking the college football world right now. No matter how this game ends, I mean, maybe Georgia comes roaring back and they take over this one. This always is already becoming a story, the fact that South Carolina, where they are, and Georgia's showing some vulnerability, and that three-peat looks like it could be in jeopardy.
And again, the game is at halftime now. He started 16 of 18 in this game. Rattler did. He was 83% coming into the game against that vaunted defense. What a story. Meanwhile, great story at BC. Seminoles in New England. It's Red Bandana Day there at Boston College. Wells Crowder, of course, celebrating his memory. Florida State was in a street fight, Danny.
They were. There you go. 24-10. Felt like they were going to take control of the game. Then they're trying to close it out. But Elijah Jones, Boston College, comes up, forces the fumble for a Victor Nelson scoop and score. All of a sudden, we got a game on our hands. Then Boston College trying to make something happen. Castellanos running for his life. Florida State defense comes up big, forces the turnover. It wants me to say escape the win, but that was never a doubt.
Okay, Danny Cannell. Western Kentucky against Trevion Henderson and the Buckeyes.
Trevion Henderson is downhill. He gets the corner, takes it into the end zone for the score, and this is Trevion
Henderson
again.
Side.
This is
Henderson
great vision, powering his way into the end zone from 7 yards out. Buckeyes with a 14-3 lead.
Yeah, Kyle McCord getting a vote of confidence. Jalen Milrow, no vote of confidence. The new quarterback for Alabama is Tyler Buckner. A struggle early. They are down 3-0. The game in a delay, a weather delay. Second quarter there at South Florida. And again, the Bulls leading 3-0. Tyler Buckner is 4 of 10. Ooh, was it the right time for the Tide to make the change at quarterback?
I hated it. Again, we talked about it last night. I thought it reeked of a panic move. I felt like you threw Jalen Milrow under the bus. Mm-hmm. If you wanted to start Ty Buckner, why not let him start week one, get his feet under him, and then you don't have these issues now because the offense still looks clunky.
There's more to this story that we don't know, okay? Someone got pissed off or angry about someone not starting, and someone said, I want my guy in. They just knee-jerk reaction, put him in. I think it was too soon, and now you're seeing the result.
It's one thing to get off to a tough start, then the rain starts pouring, and now you're in a delay. So if you're Buckner, this is worst-case scenario for your first start at Alabama. Coming up on the Ram Halftime Report, we'll catch you up on another ranked team in action. Did Central Michigan go into South Bend with a Chippewa on its shoulder against the top 10 Fighting Irish? Stick around. Highlights next.
Though we are many, we are part of something, a force bigger than all of us. Our distinct fingerprints, collectively shaping and forever changing. What makes UConn, UConn. Forever making our mark. Forever making UConn a part of us.
Mass General Brigham. When you need some of the brightest minds in medicine, this is a leading healthcare system with 5 nationally ranked hospitals, including 2 world-renowned academic medical centers. In Boston, where biotech innovates daily, and our doctors teach at Harvard Medical School, and the physicians doing the world-changing research are the ones providing care. There's only one Mass General Brigham.
Your first home sees a lot of firsts. From first loves to first steps. Sure, it can be a handful at times, keeping you up at night.
Come on now.
But with help from the Home Depot,
thank you very much.
You'll find the confidence to create the first place you call your own. The Home Depot, how doers get more done.
Introducing new buttermilk biscuits in sweet and savory flavors. So everyone can have their perfect biscuit. Or add one on the side. Get a breakfast biscuit sandwich with a side for just $7 for a limited time.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me. Always. Every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
Will you pause it real quick? Just sold the car to Carvana.
What?
All I had to do was answer a couple of questions and got a real offer in seconds. Then they just picked up the car and paid me right on the spot.
Sell your car at Carvana.com today.
Are you guys watching? This is my favorite part. Are you watching?
Okay, time to get your own bed, Hank.
Chewy has great prices.
Hope you like Plaid.
I do. Who wants popcorn?
Get more of what your pet loves with everyday great prices and fast free shipping at Chewy.
It's easy to get lost in investment research. Introducing J.P. Morgan Personal Advisors.
Hey, David.
Connect with an advisor to create your personalized plan.
Let's find the right investments for your goals.
Okay, great.
J.P. Morgan Wealth Management.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spray Flonase Sensimist daily for non-drowsy, long-lasting relief in a scent-free gentle mist. Flonase, all good. Also, try our allergy, headache, and nighttime pills.
Welcome back in South Bend. Number 9 Notre Dame hosting Central Michigan.
Sam Hartman has been a godsend for the Fighting Irish. Here he is early finding Chris Tyree, the 76-yard touchdown pass. That put Notre Dame up 21-7. But Chase Bauer with the 1-yard touchdown run. The Chippewas aren't going away quietly. And then Sam Hartman takes it on his own there with the 1 yard after capping a 78-yard drive. 28-17 right now.
San Diego State on CBS got housed by UCLA last week, this time against Oregon State.
DJ Uiagalelei on the throwback screen to Joshua Gray. 3-yard touchdown, extending the Beaver lead, 12-3 at halftime.
That is a San Diego State score if there ever was one. All right, we were looking forward to this one, Danny. Minnesota, number 20 North Carolina, Drake May off to a hot start.
Yeah, it's a good thing to see because on the season he only had 2 touchdowns, 2 interceptions, but gets it going here early. Nate McCollum, the catch for the 46-yard touchdown pass, heels up 7-0. Then Omarion Hampton, who's leading the country in the Power 5 in rushing, takes it in there. 21-10, Tar Heels up.
287, 2 scores, but 2 picks for Drake May. Okay, Oklahoma, heck of a start for Dylan Gabriel against Tulsa.
He's slanging it. Who didn't know he could slang it? 34 yards to Jalen Farouk. Sooners up. Dylan Gabriel this time with a handoff to Drake Stoops for the 4-yard score. Lunar Sooners lead 14-0. And this is Danny Stutzman picking off Roman Fuller and taking it back. Pick 6 to the house. Sooners with a lead.
First half, 3:15 and 4 scores for Gabriel. Again, first half. Meantime, halftime, Duke and Northwestern, 17-7. Duke leads. Just underway, UCLA and North Carolina Central scoreless. And mid-second, Western Michigan hanging around 25th-ranked Iowa. 7-all in that game. In our game, one-sided FIU. Kewon Jenkins, as Kevin aptly noted early on in this halftime, has been dealing, hitting Jalen Bracey down the middle for the touchdown. FIU 24-3, more to come.
Let's get to work. Someone's in the system.
It's a cyber attack.
We have to do something.
Little
your secrets come out?
I am offering you a lifeline.
You're selling UBA to Paul Marks.
He's ruthless. I made a huge mistake.
You broke every rule.
How do you sit in that chair every night?
Your dog is the one you wanted. You want what's best for them. So, ask your vet about new NexGard Plus. It's one-and-done monthly protection from fleas and ticks, plus heartworm disease, roundworms, and hookworms, all in a delicious beef-flavored soft chew. Use with caution in dogs with a history of seizures or neurologic disorders. From the maker of number one vet-recommended HeartGard Plus, NexGard Plus, the one you want for one-and-done protection.
On a heartbreaking Fansville by Dr. Pepper.
So this is goodbye?
Tech's moving to a new conference.
So we're not rivals anymore? What about our history?
This realignment's bigger than us both, but here. I got you something to remember me by.
Dr. Pepper zero sugar?
Zero. Like the odds if you make the playoff. Gotta go.
I'll always hate you and your overrated school.
I'll hate yours too.
We're still gonna out-recruit you.
We have higher academic standards.
Dr. Pepper, the one fans deserve.
Over the years, I've seen what loyalty can do for business. These people have helped me build this company from the ground up. And I want them to know how much I value their commitment. So I'm doing what I can to help secure their future. Because true loyalty goes both ways.
The Jersey Mike's catering box is the easiest way to feed your friends. The hard part is picking your sub. That's why we're having a draft. With the first pick, Sarah from Carolina selects number 13, the original Italian.
You know, I trusted my gut, and that's exactly where the sub's gonna go, so.
Hold on, we've got a trade. Jake traded his second pick with me, because I'm starved.
Freshly sliced subs to go, wherever you and your friends go. Jersey Mike's, a sub above.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me, always, every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
When you have something to get done today, getting everything you need today is helpful. That's why Ace has free in-store and curbside pickup, or even same-day delivery from your locally owned neighborhood Ace.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Second half in moments at UConn. It's 24-3, hometown team getting beat off a great season. Obviously, they got to turn things around quickly, Danny.
Yeah, I think offensively, you got to remember, you can't score 21 points in one play. You got to start to put together some drives, build some confidence. But the other thing you want to do is not give up 28, you know, make that lead 28. So the defense has to get some stops.
Yeah.
Kiwon Jenkins has been great. Good comment there, Kevin. Jalen Bracey as well. 24-3, second half next.
This has been the Ram Trucks Halftime Report. Ram Trucks, built to serve.
You know, they say losing hope, that's the real disaster. Last year, Tropical Storm Fred sent a devastating wall of water and debris down this river. And when the waters receded, Belfour was here. Not just to rebuild, but to help restore the life of this community. Belfour, restoring more than property.
Old Trapper Beef's fake protein.
Guys, can we take a quick protein break? Protein City. I got my beans, my bars, my goos, my glumps, my fizz. I don't know what that one is, but you want in?
I'm good, man.
I think Goop was a bad choice.
Old Trap, what's your beef?
Wow, you guys did great with this place.
Yeah.
And it was easy to buy with all the help we got from Navy Federal Credit Union.
I can't imagine where we'd be without them.
Great! What's shaking?
Nothing. Nothing's shaking.
Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission.
Yeah.
Bringing in a new roommate to save money, is that the plan?
Well, we gotta find some way to save, so say hi to Glenn from work.
Hey, that's my mom.
I think I have a much better plan. We switched to my plan from Verizon. We get exactly what we want and save big. All on the network we can count on.
It's a good plan.
It is a good plan. Glenn, looks like we're not gonna be needing you, so I'll see you at work.
Oh, later, Glenn.
This week, new and current customers get a free Samsung Galaxy S23 plus Galaxy Watch and Tab. All three, all on us. That's a savings of over $1,800. Offer ends soon. It's your Verizon.
At Papa John's, we start with better. Like these all-new boneless chicken wings. Juicy all-white meat chicken, lightly breaded and baked to a crispy golden brown. Try them with our new zesty sauce. Find our new boneless wings on the Papa Pairings menu. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
Getting set for the start of the second half. Christian Fourier, the Chase first half stats. All Panthers through 30 minutes.
All Panthers, and more importantly, all Kiwan lights out Jenkins with just doing everything from running it to throwing it. Huskies really have no answer on either side of the ball.
He was awesome first half. First road start for the 18-year-old true freshman. Doesn't turn 19 until early November, turning the lights out on the UConn defense.
He has been fabulous. And I tell you, there's an obvious disparity between the defensive backs for UConn and the receivers for FIU. And he, Jenkins, has been dropping dimes left and right when you think about just everything he's doing. Now, watch him kind of throw the football. When you think about the way he's throwing the football, and they're all long passes, 45 yards, 64, 48, two touchdowns through the air, 17 yards on the ground, and one touchdown. There isn't anything that he can't do. What an unbelievable throw. The receivers are winning right off the line, and the UConn defensive backs can't keep up with them. And then if they decide to kind of go back and play cover two and let's stop the deep ball, he just runs it up the middle. And, of course, when we saw this, this was the first drive, the touchdown, the tush push that you see the Philadelphia Eagles doing so much.
For obvious reasons, the subject of Pound for Pound brought to you by Rogue Fitness. What a first half for Jenkins. Domino ventures out. On the return for UConn. And cut down outside the 15. Back down to Keanu Martin.
To Mike McIntyre, and he said that he is overall pleased with the performance of this team, especially on defense. He said outside of that big run that was given up in the first quarter, he said the energy has been great. He wants them to continue this the next two quarters. But as for Jim Mora, UConn's head coach, a complete opposite. He hasn't found a single positive in this game. He said they're playing like an awful team, and if they don't get their act together soon, this is going to be a very long season for UConn.
Trying to avoid 0-3 here, Keanu. Thanks for that. The coach told us pregame on the field, I think my team is ready. We had a great week of practice. We felt prepared last week on the way to Atlanta. Laid an egg against Georgia State on 14 through 30 minutes. Same result today against FIU of Conference USA. Said we've got to prove it on the field. They haven't so far. Houston feature back. Roberson runs the show. Houston runs the ball. C.J. Christian runs him out of bounds.
Well,
nice pick up though on first down.
That'll help. And there's number 51, Yukari Walker, with a nice block. Good job by Houston. I mean, that is when things aren't going well, they just lean on their running game. And I actually feel like they should kind of take the kind of attitude that they had last week in the second half and let Roberson throw it.
Big day for Houston so far. Team's second leading rusher behind Victor Rosa entering play today. Run a 13, first down for the Huskies. Great start, second half. Houston again, toes the rock, runs into trouble. A lot of white jerseys.
A lot of white
Alex
jerseys.
Alex Nobles led the way here, Christian.
Yeah, and number 02, Jack Daly, did a good job. And then you also had Donovan Manuel filling those holes. I think it's obvious they know that these run downs, I mean, they are just committing to stopping the run, and that is it. And these linebackers are so fast, and a guy like Nobles is so good off the back end, chasing down any one of those stretch plays, they can't get to the edge quick enough.
Jack Daly, local hero, South Glastonbury, with the pressure, the big hit, and the pass to Jolie, who gets dropped by Manuel right away. Another big loss for UConn's offense, struggling.
They try to run like a quick bubble screen, but Daly doesn't fall for anything. And the offensive lineman can't get out to the edge quick enough to block for Joe Lee. So this play hasn't worked once for him all day, but they just keep going to it.
Man, the big man can motor there. Family and friends from nearby South Plastibury. About a 10-minute drive from where we are here in East Hartford. 100-plus are here to watch Jack Daly. They've got to be happy so far. A transfer from Bryant in the FCS. Third down. Huskies need something here. Roberson, lots of time. Delivers. Buckman has the grab. First down, UConn, and then some. Brett Buckman breaks a tackle. Cross territory. Still going. Potts finally has the play, but there is a flag down back of the 22. It's a gain of 40 if it stands here for UConn. Let's check out the marker.
Boy, this is going to be a killer for them if this is a holding penalty.
Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense number two. That 15-yard penalty is, of course, going to end the run. First down.
Avery Huff's number two for FIU. Let's see.
Yeah, Buckman's the guy that transferred from Delaware. One of the best, had one of the best camps out of everyone, all that offense. And good job running after the catch. Had 9 catches last week, most of them in the second half, too, and a touchdown. And here's the roughing the passer just a little bit too late. Who is that comes in? Oh, he hits him on the head, too. That's number 8. That's number 8. And number 2. That's Avery Huff.
So plus 15. And all the way to the 16 now for UConn. Trying to get his first touchdown of the day. Great first drive. Misery since. Pitch Houston. Devontae Houston runs into trouble. Gets hit hard.
Yeah, Yukari Walker
backwards.
He pulls as a center. He gets up and he pulls and he's running, but he overruns the block.
Elijah Anderson Taylor, big hit, Christian.
So if and a big hit on Devontae Houston. Oh!
Off a loss of 2. Roberson. And free leaps and can't bring it in. Zeke Massis on coverage, the corner for FIU on the overthrown ball from Taquan Roberson.
This is the second time he missed. That's just too high. I know he's got some hops, but one, he has to stop short, and two, the ball is too far over his head. I don't know if he was expecting like a high point ball or if he should have kept running through it. Seems like those two, at least on the last two plays that they've missed, haven't hit.
Could be down by 21, 3 scores, 4 down territory. Let's see what Coach Moore has got in mind based on the third down play. Loss in motion. Sprint right. Roberson throws back. Jolie has the catch. Flag flies. Jolie has a great move. Has the first down, lunging ahead. Shy got to the 1. There is a flag down at the 27. And it's possibly a late hit. Again on the FIU defense.
Personal foul, roughing the passer. Defense, number 90. That penalty is, of course, half the distance to the goal.
First and goal for UConn. Penalty on Passmore.
It's just a tight end screen, and Jolie follows his blockers and does a nice job almost getting that touchdown. And then here's the late hit on Roberson. Oh, no, they're going to go to the touchdown.
Stafford, the big man, stack backfield. He carries, he's in, touchdown, Elijah Stafford. Defensive lineman has got a touchdown run for UConn. How about it? The big dude for 6.
They were in a jam last week and last year, and there was some talk, some rumors going around that Jelani Stafford would play running back, because he did play running back a little bit in high school, so he's got that ability to carry the football.
Game changer.
That's a huge drive for UConn. They needed that desperately.
PAT Joe McFadden. The first drive of the game yielded a field goal. The first drive of the second half, 8 plays, 82 yards, 3.5 minutes, and the big defensive tackle, Jelani Stafford. First career rushing TD.
Yeah, first career rushing TD. Hey, listen, you want to make sure there's, and leave no doubt, give it to the big fella. He's over 300 pounds.
Meet the team behind the team. The coach, the manager, and the snack dad, all using Chase to keep up with their finances. The coach helps save goals here because she saved for soccer camp there. And check this out. The manager deposited a check. Magic. And the snack dad, he's getting paid back. Orange slices. Because this team all has Chase. Smart bankers, convenient tools, one bank with the power of both. Chase, make more of what's yours.
Camp. How'd you spend the off-season?
The off-season?
Little Caesars tastes so good.
It tastes even better with my best friend.
Three best friends eating pizza all the time. Having fun. Pizza, pizza, pounds for life.
The off season? Just hit the weights.
Try the new four-quarter calzone from Little Caesars for $8.99. It's officially delicious.
Pizza, pizza.
Why do I choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
So I can keep them all guessing.
So I know their game better than they do.
So I can take my game to the next level.
Because when your bed is this smart, you sleep at the right temperature all night. That's why 80% of NFL players choose the Sleep Number smart bed.
Whoa.
Yeah, he always goes big.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
Wow, thorough. Does he know the party's not till next week?
Expert thinker!
Let's invite Jacques.
Let's not invite Jacques.
Whoa!
Jerry struggles on conference calls, but he's such a dedicated employee.
You're right. Hey, Jacques.
Come join us.
Strong winds.
College football on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Sonic 399 Bacon Peppercorn Ranch Grilled Cheeseburger. For a limited time, only at Sonic. By T-Mobile 5G Home Internet. Check availability in your area. And by Chase. Make more of what's yours.
2023 national champs, UConn. Dan Hurley's squad, magical season, capping off with a victory against San Diego State of the Mountain West. Bringing home the program's fifth national title. Jalen Bracey deep to receive the kick. That's through the end zone for a touchback. And we got to meet Coach Hurley a couple weeks back. Came into the booth for you. Pretty cool, right?
Yeah, it was actually. It was funny. Like, you know, you win a championship and you take the victory tour. They went to Italy. They took all these, you know, went and saw you get all these cool events that you get to go to. He was in Italy. He was finally like, yeah, I think I'm done with this. I said, wait, well, you can't be done with going to Italy for free, right?
He's a Hurley.
He's ready to go back to work. Yeah, it was like, all right.
He was ready to get back to it. Yeah. No doubt. Jamari Lawrence, feature back here. We'll see how the kid lights out, they call him. Got the nickname as a youngster playing video games. And he has been electric today. 18-year-old true freshman, Kewan Jenkins. Hands to Bracey. Jalen Bracey bounces outside. And a nice pickup.
That name needs a... take on new meaning. Like lights out need to literally refer to just how good he is. And even on this last play, just a quick little, like, you know, screen, a handoff for the wide receiver to get as wide as possible, and UConn has a hard time chasing them down. So anything on the edges where the backers or the DBs have to chase is going to be a struggle for UConn.
Good pickup. Play fake. Jenkins throws. Has his tight end, Jackson McDonald. Makes a nice move. First down, FIU. Play made by Stan Cross. Free safety for UConn. Chain mover, gain of 8, and the tight end's effective for the Panthers.
Yeah, and on this time, the UConn comes with the blitz right up the middle. And then McDonald, nice job on the nice little waggle route and making the guy miss, get that first down.
Great numbers so far for the freshman. That includes a FIU freshman record, 292 yards. In his first game, that was against Maine. First career start at home, FIU Stadium in Miami. What a emerging star at Conference USA. Quite a story. Mesh play, not much doing there for Jamari Lawrence. Back down to Kiana.
Hey guys, so I heard you guys refer to him as Lights Out. Well, friends, teammates, even coaches called Kawan Jenkins Lights Out. He's actually got that name over a decade ago playing a video game. It was his character on NBA 2K. And back then when playing basketball, the announcers were looking for nicknames to give for the players. Well, he told them he wants to go by Lights Out. He won MVP that year and won a championship in his league, and it's been Lights Out ever since, fellas.
Has he ever, Kiana? 28 starts in a row. He's won over high school and college. Looking for another one here. Looks for Patterson, the deep ball, who adjusts, but can't bring it in. It's incomplete. Armani Archie on coverage on the sideline route to Patterson.
Well, it's obvious that they want to take advantage of some of these young corners. This one, he just underthrows it. The safety is still not in anywhere to actually make a play. Just underthrows it. Can't bring the football down. Anything on the edge, if they see an obvious mismatch, they are going deep. I think they believe they can run by anybody.
I believe they can. Seen it a lot today. Third down, pressure comes. Jenkins delivers. Mitchell can't bring it in. A bit behind him. And incomplete. Mumu Bin Wahoud has the coverage there defensively for UConn. Punt time for the Panthers.
Yeah, I actually thought this was not a bad throw. It just feels like number 10 Chris Mitchell wasn't ready for it, but this is the ball he's got to bring down. Third down, big play. They just went down and scored. You got to keep this drive going. UConn going to get another chance on offense quickly.
All right, you're a former tight end at the highest level.
Yes.
Is it possible for a quarterback to throw the ball too hard? Because this kid's got an arm.
Well, you can't. That is, yes, absolutely.
Okay.
And you asked me earlier, I played with Tom Brady, played with right. Warren Moon, played with a lot of guys. Easily, Warren Moon had the easiest catchable pass regardless of anybody I've ever played with.
All right, Jenkins can sure throw it. 32-yard punt, timeout at East Hartford, Connecticut.
At Papa John's, we start with better. Like these all-new boneless chicken wings. Juicy all-white meat chicken, lightly breaded and baked to a crispy golden brown. Try them with our new zesty sauce. Find our new boneless wings on the Papa Pairings menu. Better ingredients, better pizza, Papa John's.
The fact that this Reese's ad showed up at this exact moment proves that your devices are listening to your stomach.
Give it up for the big hurt, Frank Thomas. Congratulations, Frank.
Hey,
Andy, Doug, you guys look great.
Hey, I feel great, too. Ever since you told me about Nugenix Total T, I'm crushing my workouts.
Thanks to Nugenix, I got more energy, more stamina, feeling years younger.
From the brand that brought you GNC's number one vitality product and product of the year, Nugenix Total T is our most powerful man-boosting formula ever. Because it boosts your free testosterone and your total testosterone. To get your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T, text GO to 231-231.
I like the competitive edge Nugenix gives me. Hey, me too. Guys over 40, you need Nugenix Total T, and she'll like it too.
Text GO to 231-231 for your complimentary bottle of Nugenix Total T. Plus, text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, to help you get back into shape fast, absolutely free. That's G-O to 231-231.
Here's your parachute.
Packed it myself.
Certain it's okay?
Mm-hmm.
Are you for imprint certain?
Certainty matters, like the certainty of congratulating coworkers or saying thank you for being a customer with promotional products from 4imprint. Our expert team is dedicated to making your satisfaction a certainty.
Packed it myself.
Land the perfect products at 4imprint.com.
4imprint, for certain.
First of three straight home games for UConn FAU today. Next week, number 21, Duke. 3:30 Eastern, then Utah State coming as well. Three straight on the home field. And the home team, Christian, good last drive for a touchdown.
Oh, yeah, and they're hitting all the playmakers for this UConn team. Buckman with his first reception, the big run after catch. And then it's a tight end screen with an unsportsmanlike penalty on the FIU, but it didn't really matter because he got it to the one. And then the big defensive tackle, Jelani Stafford with the tackle. He also made a couple plays on defense the very next series.
Great drive. Tough first half. We're on that opening drive for Jim Morris Huskies. Back on the field here. Play fake. Jolie bobbles. And it's incomplete. Almost an interception. Massis was right there looking for a pick. Joey's dropped a couple today.
Yeah, it's the second one, and he actually has some room right here. Just another quick little tight end bubble, and he's got his blockers out there, but he just can't hold on to it. That's the second drop of the day.
Last Husky drive aided by two personal fouls, 15-yard calls against FIU's defense for late hits on Taquan Roberson. UConn's starting QB again. Again last year, starter at Utah State in Logan. Had a touchdown run, got an official timeout here on the initial drive.
Game clock operator, please reset the game clock to 9 minutes and 30 seconds, please.
All right, get the clock straight here.
Thank you.
Referee out of Newark, Delaware. Roberson had to wait a long time. 10-month rehab, ACL tear, second drive last season. Lost the job to Joe Fagnano, who was lost last week at Georgia State. Season-ending shoulder injury. Had surgery yesterday. Roberson the man again. Houston on the carry. Thompson was all man there. And down he goes. Alex Nobles was there, but actually Kerry Walker, the center, and Houston collide.
Yeah, and big number nine, Will Pendergrass, did a good job as a no guard right there, just pushing Yukari back right there. And obviously number 75, Chase Lund, can't get any movement on his end either. So that's a win for that defensive line of FIU.
Five receivers here for Roberson. Third down number so far you saw bottom of your screen. Third and 10. Taquan Roberson delivers.
Hits
the official and it's incomplete. It happens. The official is part of the field. It was intended for Cam Ross. And occasionally that does happen in college football. Stephen Marshall is the umpire. Incomplete pass. Punt time for UConn.
I don't know. Let's see. Yeah, he got a good chance of catching that pass right there. At least duck. I mean, maybe he just. I mean, that's got to be frustrating right there. That's got to drive you nuts because he was open. And that was a good, decent crossing route by Cam Ross and just FIU playing with 12.
Here are 10 punts again to Patterson. Tough break for the Huskies. Dean Patterson sees some room. Flag. Well, that's equipment flag, not a penalty flag. Yeah. Towel was
airborne.
Yeah,
it's like somebody's
there.
Towel.
It's white, not yellow. 10-yard return off the 39-yard punt. And FIU against Jim Moore's team back on the field. Up by two scores in East Hartford, Connecticut.
Today we recognize the soldiers before you for the successful completion of their basic training. This time we would like for family members and loved ones to move forward and put on your soldiers' Army One-Star patch.
Proud of you.
Those new tiles are falling right into place until you run out of what are those called again? Oh, right. The Home Depot app is made for doing that doesn't miss a beat. So you can find what you need fast and keep things moving in the right direction. For doing that doesn't stop, download the Home Depot app. It's made for doing.
Papa John's garlic sauce fans, we made the Garlic Epic Stuffed Crust Pizza just for you. With that garlic flavor.
In it, on it, with it.
But you wanted more heat, so now you can get it in spicy. Get a one topping for $13.99 only at Papa John's.
Whoa.
Yeah, he always goes big.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
Wow, thorough.
Does he know the party's not till next week?
Sometimes you feel like a nut.
Sometimes you don't.
Almond Joy's got nuts and something even way better than that. Yes, Almond Joy is made with almonds and joy.
I do the impossible, impossible.
FIU 2-1, but the three games decided by a total of 14 points. Close calls for the Panthers so far this year, trying to win on the road here today in Connecticut. Geico difference makers. Houston Christian's had a good outing so far for the Huskies.
Yeah, and as obviously, you know, when they get Devontae Houston going, they start threatening that edge. I tell you what, that'll really stress out a defense. And as you can see, 79 yards so far. And then Kiwan Jenkins. I was going to start calling him Lights Out, doing it through the air, doing it on the ground. Two touchdowns.
Lights Out of the offense back on the field here. Freshman's been spectacular so far. Try to continue that. What a good throw. Artez Hooker, first touch, first catch of the game. Back down to count with more on Kiwan Jenkins.
Hey, guys, I spoke to a staff member about Jenkins, and he said if he had to give me a professional comparison, he would match him to the likes of Drew Brees. He said it's the height, the accuracy, the confidence, and his ability to move around and get himself free. Needless to say, the team believes he has that it factor, guys.
I think he does. Well, Scott, we had a nice chat with him on Zoom this week. He is a confident young man, super bright. Clearly a grasp of the Panther offense. Gain of 13 to Jenkins. Run play. Here's Owens on the move. Good pickup. Got 11. Chains move again here for FIU. They are rolling offensively.
Yeah, there's number zero, Shamari Showtime Lawrence now. Pressing that edge, cutting that back, and just getting upfield. He is such a violent runner. Now he's 6 feet tall, about 200 pounds, and you would think he wouldn't have the ability to make people miss, and you haven't seen it a ton so far today. But watching games on him, I mean, he can run inside the tackles, and when he gets free, he can make a safety miss.
Owens with the game-winning touchdown against North Texas in that wild shootout at FIU Stadium last week. Part of a really good 2-1 FIU start, best start since 2018 when the program won 9 games and went to a bowl. McIntyre trying to bring the Panthers back. On first down, what's it all? Mitchell can't gather, incomplete at the goal line. Romo bin Wahad on coverage for UConn.
Well, again, there they go. I mean, they get off the line. These FIU receivers get off the line so quickly, almost an interception. They've been doing this all day. Mitchell off, he gets that hand in there. I mean, he's got to feel good about himself. I mean, be careful standing over the receiver like that. You're going to get a personal foul call. Unsportsmanlike conduct. I thought the ref was going to actually throw a flag on him for standing over Mitchell.
Near taunting call, you're right. Play fake, pressure off the edge. Was Jackson Mitchell in pursuit. So is Plack, and eventually Jenkins wisely throws that to the sideline, incomplete to live another down.
Is it me, or does UConn really feel like they have the advantage now based on the way the game is going? They're making the right calls on defense. I mean, they're taking those same shots that were crippling to this UConn defense. They've twice so far, it's either been a bad throw or a good defensive play.
Panthers 2 for 7, third down, big one here. UConn thinking comeback again. Jenkins incomplete on 4 of his last 5 passing attempts.
Now remember, when they played against NC State, Brendan Armstrong, their quarterback, rushed for almost 100 yards, and all of them came off of broken plays, scrambling plays, because UConn couldn't tackle them. Same situation here, 3rd and 10.
Jenkins delivers. Too tall. Trying there for Artez Hooker, incomplete.
I like the call by Jim Moore here on defense, sending an extra person, sending an extra backer. So the one thing you can't do is let Jenkins sit back there and just throw it on you, because obviously he's accurate enough to make those throws. So challenge him a little bit. And this time he has to run backwards basically and trying to throw a football with his left arm fading backwards and to his right to a receiver running to his right. Difficult throw.
Montiel punts to Buckman. Buckman. Indicates 4 and makes a fair catch to the 14, and that's where UConn gets the rock right back here for Jim Mora. Trying to get within a touchdown against FIU of Conference USA.
Let's go!
Meet the future. A chef, a designer, and ooh, an engineer. All learning to save and spend their money with Chase. The chef's cooking up first with her new debit card.
Hungry?
Uh-huh. The designer's eyeing sequins, plaid. While mom is eyeing his spending. Nice. And the engineer? She's taking control with her own account for college. 3 futures, all with Chase. Freedom for kids, control for parents. 1 bank for both. Chase, make more of what's yours.
Why do I choose a Sleep Number smart bed?
so I can keep them all guessing.
So I know their game better than they do. So I can take my game to the next level.
Because when your bed is this smart, you sleep at the right temperature all night. That's why 80% of NFL players choose the Sleep Number Smart Bed.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me. Always. Every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you prime. You want to stay prime, right?
Today, I'm doing the Degree Gray T-shirt challenge. Let's put Degree Advanced and Allspice to the test and see if I get any sweat marks.
Final result? Only one winner here.
No sweat marks.
Degree Advanced keeps working when others stop.
Teeth sensitivity is so common. It immediately feels like somebody's poking directly on the nerve. I recommend Sensodyne. Sensodyne toothpaste goes inside the tooth and calms the nerve down. And my patients say, you know, doc, it really works.
When game time runs into dinner time, a hero must rise. Like DiGiorno Rising Crust Pizza. Because delicious fresh baked taste straight from your oven always wins. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
Brett Stover in New York, number one, Georgia's trailed the entire game, but Dylan Bell with a short touchdown run. Dogs go in front of South Carolina in the third, 17-14. Dave Ryan and the big tight end, Christian Fourier.
Hey, Brett, thanks so much. I love that toss. Brent Stover, thank you. Good game there between the hedges as Georgia tries to go 3-0.
That was Brent Stover, country singing phenomenon.
Legend.
Legend.
Don't check him out on YouTube.
Don't
check
him out. Yeah, check him out on YouTube.
He's way good. Really. Roberson. And the offense take over here. Rosa. Good run, first down. Runs over tacklers, gets aggressive with DeVeric Daniel and drives him forward a couple yards. It's a pickup of nearly 11. First down here for UConn.
Yeah, it was number 75. You may not be able to see it, but we're talking about prying a guy out of the hole. The number 75, he saw his butt at the last second. Just getting that hole, just enough space for Rosa to get through there and get positive yardage.
100 rushing yards for the team now for UConn. They ran for 295 against FIU last year in Miami. Only prior meeting between these two schools. Play fake, Roberson. Here comes the pressure from CJ Christian all over him. Flag flies.
Now it's dead. You can't do that, though. That's the type of mistake right now they're calling for intentional grounding.
Christian was really close to Roberson's helmet, too. Let's see. He went to the face mask as he tried to block the pass. That could be another personal foul. Had a couple of those already in the second half.
It looked to me like he was knew he was going to get gotten. He threw the football down, even though it was underhand. It was an obvious, hey, I'm passing the football. This may be what they're discussing. Maybe it's offsetting. And there's two now.
Two
just another one. Like dropping the mic, actually.
Right. There are multiple fouls committed on the play. Personal foul, roughing the passer, defense. Intentional grounding, offense. Those penalties offset, it's first down.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean you're this is their third unsportsmanlike conduct by he hits
right
him in the head with his hands. Yeah, and you can't do that, obviously. But even though, like, these are the type of decisions that Roberson needs to be better with, that you can't do that. They're lucky that it's not a fumble, to be honest with you, the way he kind of, it's very, it's not even really clear.
Not great for either player there. Replay first down. Ross in motion. Play fake to Rosa. Again, that low throw, Jolie.
Well, at least this time he's out of the tackle box.
Right, so not grounding this time.
Yeah.
FIU doesn't. Taylor all over him.
Yeah, FIU doesn't fall for the play fake. The entire offensive line went to the left, play action pass. And he's trying to get Jolie on a quick slam and release, and he's covered. And the crosser is covered also. He just throws in there. That was a smart decision.
Good pressure by Alex Nobles. Had a sack and a half against Maine. North Carolina transfer. He's been effective for FIU here today. Second down. Rosa the speedster. Not much. Manuel again.
Yeah.
He has just been everywhere. Transfer from East Tennessee State. And once he got the diet straight, lost some weight in the offseason and bulked up with good weight, he has been even better for FIU.
Yeah, and what I'm seeing right now is that offensive line, like, initially they're doing a good job right now, like, winning at the line, winning at the point of attack, but Manuel is so good at closing and getting these backs once he finds an opening. And that's been the difference right now.
Want to get something going for offensive coordinator Nick Charlton, former head coach at Maine. Tennessee Joe Fagnano's head coach there. On third down, Roberson delivers. Joey has the catch. Dix route. Blades the tackle along with C.J. Christian. Chains move. Much needed for UConn. Gain of 11. Nice delivery from Roberson.
Yeah, the slant route for Joey is such a important part of his bag of tricks, and you saw it earlier in the game. He dropped a quick little screen pass, so that's got to make him feel really good and give Roberson some confidence also that he can stick it in there and he'll come down with it.
Clock rolls, first downs, except end of the second and fourth quarters are 2 minutes to go. Jolie, Ross, the pitch, Wilson. Can Ross have a catch and the pitch a little end around play, but read nicely. Elijah Anderson Taylor strung it out and made sure UConn got nothing going.
Yeah, and there's Nick Charlton, offensive coordinator. Now, at least once a game, he will have some sort of trick play that he will bring out. He does it every single game, but this time it's the quick bubble screen with the follow by Rosa. But like you said, FIU in the right spot to make the tackle.
208 total yards of offense. UConn has struggled for the most part today. Except for the initial drives in the first and third quarters.
No safety.
Trying to get something cooking here. Roberson, time, surveys, delivers. Ross has the catch. Daniel runs him out of bounds for FIU. It's a pickup of 9. It sets up a really important play here for the Huskies.
Yeah, and last week against North Texas, Roberson was 19 of 30 for 216 yards, 2 touchdowns. A career best for him, especially with attempts, 30 attempts throwing the football. And Moore even said, well, he kind of dismissed it a little bit because, they're empty yards. But it seems like that had an impact on the way he's playing today, especially in the second half. The first half, boy, it was tough. I mean, he couldn't find anybody. He couldn't hit open receivers. Totally different Roberson in the second half.
Lewis Hansen, 3-star recruit. Sophomore, Massachusetts. Michigan transfer in there. The 3-back set. Stafford again. The big man gets it. Has a first down for UConn. 300 pounds of power. Jelani Stafford. A touchdown run and a first down play for the Huskies.
Now the power and the foundation of this team is their offensive line. The only guy that is not a returning star is number 51, the center, Yukari Walker. All other four guys have been there for a while. So they go right over Christian Hayes, the All-American right guard. And they say, big boy, don't worry about my back. Just get the yards.
I'll give him to him more. Wait, it's gone today. Post a feature back here. Roberson on first down. Time delivers. Buckman behind him and can't bring it in. Incomplete. Zeke Massis has the breakup for FIU. Back down to Kiana.
Hey guys, so Jelani Stafford, we saw him get that first down, and then we also saw him with that touchdown earlier today. Well, he was actually a running back along with a D lineman in high school. Last year, he joked with all of the injuries in the running back room. He said, hey, put me in. This is actually his first game ever getting a carry, and he got a first down as well as a touchdown earlier, guys.
He's been awesome, Keon, no doubt about that. I say give it to him more, Christian.
I think you've created a monster. You know, you can't give him a little bit, take it away from him.
Rosa. Runs left, not much, maybe a yard. On the first down carry, Manuel at the bottom of the pile again. It's been something else. Senior from Ellenwood, Georgia. East Tennessee State transfer, 9 tackles last week against North Texas. 6th in the country, 13 tackles a game. The Mike Backer is a tackle machine for the Panthers.
Now they just brought in number 2, Avery Huff. Now he is when they think there is going to be a pass, they put Avery Huff in. Here he is right here. He's usually a third down specialist, getting after the quarterback.
Draw 3rd and 9 for the Husky offense. Roberson lit up some pressure. Blades the tackle. Buckman has the reception. Got to the 49 plus territory.
He's holding him now.
Gain of 3.
There they go.
Jim Mora will punt.
I feel like he was thinking about it.
You thought about it.
Because I'm saying, well, you know, the one thing I was going to say is that they're not panicking right now. It's too early. It's too early right now. I know they're booing him right now, but the defense has been playing pretty good, so you think that, you know, they'll keep that up and get him the ball back.
Good pressure. Elijah Anderson Taylor. He's had a big game for FIU. Patterson back to receive the punt. No pressure. Dean Patterson watches that go to the end zone for a touchback. Panthers from their 20. A 49-yard kick from UConn's George Karatan. FIU has been in the face of Taquan Roberson today quite a bit, Christian.
Yeah, they have, and whether they're stunting from a four-man front or they're just getting home naturally, they've been doing a good job forcing Roberson either to hold the football too long or make errant throws like you saw right there, just getting there right in time. And even when they do some sort of play-action pass, everybody's in the right spot, making it really hard on him to get into a rhythm.
A lot of QBHs, right? Quarterback hurries in this game.
Yeah. Important for this team.
Back to the freshman. And to Lawrence, who runs into trouble. Gonna lose some territory. A lot of Huskies up front. Price Yates, Bordine and company get to FIU's running back, Shamari Lawrence.
I don't know, whatever. Listen, if you want Jelani Stafford to play better on defense, give him the ball on offense, because right now he is in the zone.
He's
made some plays the last two series on defense that have been difference makers.
But you know, you played for years. Yeah. Like, defensive guys who get the rock, score a touchdown, they're pumped.
I know, but
as I said,
you created a monster.
Second down. Jenkins flushed. Gordine right there. He's got him. Delmont Gordine, redshirt junior at Charleston, South Carolina. His career best came against Army last year with 6 tackles. And the big play, loss of 1, and the Huskies making some noise on defense.
Yeah, and this is key right here for Gordine, who's never had a bad day in his life. You're around him, and all he's doing is smiling. I know he's not smiling right now because he's a little tired, but around the locker room, around the fellas, there's not a happier guy on the team.
Final 40 ticks here of the third. Big third down for the Panthers.
3 down. Actually, 4 down with Watts up here in the corner.
2 of 8 conversions so far on third. Jenkins steps up, delivers incomplete. Looks for Mitchell. Coverage there from Ben Wahad. Good breakup for UConn. And the Panthers have to punt again in a 2-score game.
Yeah, just enough presence right there to force the ball to be knocked out. It almost feels like he was going to catch it. And Patterson can't bring it down. Good job. These DBs have had a rough day. They're starting to really play good defense.
Montiel's been busy. So has Buckman. Dayton Montier, high kick. Brett Buckman makes a fair catch at the 44, 37-yard punt. We talked about Duke coming. Duke is hammering Northwestern today, so they're about to go 3-0. On the way on CBS Sports Network next week, Utah State out of the Mountain West, the team that UConn played last year as well. Rice just beat Houston, Christian, last week in the Bayou Bucket game.
Yeah, there's no easy games for them. There's no gimmies for them. And the one thing that's been missing so far, you want me to circle James Madison? Is that your team?
I'm just worried about Tennessee.
Serious?
I'm already concerned about Tennessee.
Oh, last year when they played, remember they played Syracuse, they played Michigan, they played NC State back to back to back. And they started 1-4 last year, UConn did, and they found a way to dig themselves out of a massive hole and go to a bowl game for the first time in forever.
Well, 5 of 7. Roberson keeps on first down. CJ Christian upends him. For a good pickup, got about 5 yards plus on the run in the final moments of the third quarter.
Yeah, it's such an important series, and going into the fourth quarter, being down only 14 points, and your defense really playing lights out right now.
End of the third quarter, 15 to go here from East Hartford. 2-score lead for FIU from Conference USA. You're watching College Football on CBS Sports Network, presented by the Home Depot.
Why I love Halloween?
Why?
People give me Kit Kats for free.
Son, you're 8. All your Kit Kats are free.
Happy Halloween. Have a break. Have a Kit Kat.
How'd you spend the off season?
The off season?
Little Caesars tastes so good.
It tastes even better with my best friends.
Three best friends eating pizza all the time. Having fun. Pizza, pizza, pounds for life.
The off season? Just hit the weights.
Try the new four-quarter calzone from Little Caesars for $8.99. It's officially delicious.
Pizza, pizza.
Introducing New Starry Lemon Lime Soda. Music to my ears.
You don't have ears.
Starry. It's different.
With Flonase, allergies don't have to be scary. Spray Flonase Sensimist daily for non-drowsy, long-lasting relief in a scent-free gentle mist. Flonase, all good. Also, try our allergy headache and nighttime pills.
Look like there's a flag.
Mike, I can't keep up with you. You're racing around like you're 10 years younger. How do you stay in such great shape?
Eugenics Total, see, Ed, helps me stay leaner, stronger, and gives me back to the energy and stamina I had when I was younger.
How'd you hear about Eugenics?
You kidding? You haven't seen Frank Thomas and Doug Flutie talk about it? Men over 40, get Nugenics Total T and get back on your game.
Tell them to send a text.
Send a text.
To get your complimentary bottle of Nugenics Total T, text
BOLD to 231231.
This unique man-boosting formula is powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically validated to help increase free testosterone levels so you can trim up and stay lean.
Hey, ref, aren't you forgetting something?
Get your complimentary bottle of Nugenics now. Text BOLD to 231231. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenics Thermo, our most powerful fat incinerator ever, absolutely free.
Ramp helps companies save time and money. What can Ramp do for you? Well, this. Okay, let's back up. Ramp combines corporate cards with an intelligent finance platform all in one place. You can issue unlimited cards with spend controls, pay bills, automate receipt capture, and manage your entire business spend. With Ramp, you close your books faster so you can focus on what matters most.
Visit ramp.com to find out what Ramp can do for you.
Heading into the fourth, our Carvana game summary. Christian, break down the numbers for us here.
Well, you know, obviously the passing yards have been something I'm sure UConn would like to do something better with. And rushing the football has been there. They're over 100 yards. This stands out to me, though, Ryan, is this whole time of possession. 25 minutes, over 25 minutes for UConn, but only 10 points, and close to 20 minutes for FIU, but 24 points. But the reason is because they're scoring so quickly. They get that ball and they score so quickly, and look at this guy. I saw him during the break pacing up and down. Look at him, he's talking to himself. He wants back, he wants a third and one, is what he wants. He wants a third and one.
He's a warrior. Houston carries, first down UConn. Devontae Houston, some speed. Eric Daniel, the bandit safety, has the stop. Pickup of 9. Chains move here. UConn, critical drive to begin the fourth.
Yeah, and there's a big All-American, Christian Hayes, number 64, pulling from his right guard spot, front side, right next to the tackle in the guard, getting a nice little crease there for Houston to get some space.
UConn shows some life here. Down 2 scores, plenty of time left. Roberson, the play fake. Roberson still holds it. Now going to run with the football and run out of bounds. Anderson Taylor tracks him and sends him to the boundary.
And he got good protection there from UConn, but there's really only 4 guys rushing. They do a good job hemming them up, and nobody downfield right now because they got 7 guys in coverage, and it's just zone, but Roberson can't find anybody. But he does the right thing by just taking it down to get as much as he can. At this point in time with the game in reach, I would say. I mean, you're down 14 and you're across the 50. This game is not out of hand right now.
A lot of experience O-line led by the All-American Christian Haynes. Screen pass set up. Houston grabs it. Devontae Houston, first down and some. Makes a cut. Houston thinking touchdown. He's in. Touchdown Huskies. Devontae Houston.
Well, the timing couldn't have been better. This is a great call by offensive coordinator Nick Charles, because FIU has the blitz on. Christian Hayes with a good block. Then downfield, it's number 3, Jordan Porter, and number 17, Justin Jolie, with downfield blocking. And, of course, Houston with the nifty move to set up the blocks for his downfield blockers and get the touchdown.
Two touchdown passes. Roberson last week, McFadden, PAT. And Christian, we got a new game here at East Hartford, one score contest.
Yeah, we do. If you need something, great call by offensive coordinator Nick Charlton. But look at the blocking downfield. Porter down there, Jolie down there, and Houston doing the rest, getting the touchdown. Down 7.
I have type 2 diabetes, but I manage it well. It's a little pill with a big story to tell. I take once daily Jardiance. At each day start, as time went on, it was easy to see. I'm lowering my A1C.
Jardiance works 24/7 in your body to flush out some sugar. And for adults with type 2 diabetes and known heart disease, Jardiance can lower the risk of cardiovascular death too. Jardiance may cause serious side effects, including ketoacidosis that may be fatal, dehydration that can lead to a sudden worsening of kidney function, and genital yeast or urinary tract infections. A rare life-threatening bacterial infection in the skin of the perineum could occur. Stop taking Jardiance and call your doctor right away if you have symptoms of this infection, ketoacidosis, or an allergic reaction, and don't take it if you're on dialysis. Taking Jardiance with the sulfonylurea or insulin may cause low blood sugar.
Jardiance!
Wow, you guys did great with this place.
Yeah.
And it was easy to buy with all the help we got from Navy Federal Credit Union.
I can't imagine where we'd be without them.
Great!
So what's shaking?
Nothing. Nothing's shaking.
Navy Federal Credit Union. Our members are the mission.
When game time runs into dinner time, a hero must rise. Like DiGiorno Rising Crust Pizza. Because delicious fresh baked taste straight from your oven always wins. It's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
You know why I love Halloween?
Why?
People give me Kit Kats for free.
Son, you're 8. All your Kit Kats are free.
Happy Halloween! Have a break, have a Kit Kat.
College football on CBS Sports Network is sponsored by Carvana. They'll drive you happy. By Belfour, the leading disaster recovery partner for businesses and communities. By Rogue, don't weaken. And by Reese's Peanut Butter Cups.
Capital City, Connecticut, beautiful look at downtown Hartford. About a 5-minute drive here across the Connecticut River to East Hartford. Houston's first career touchdown catch a moment ago. Jalen Bracy from about the 8. The return of FIU breaks a tackle. Bracy, nice run back. And a bounce by McFadden, the kicker, does a good job, a nice return at 33.
Well, this play works. First off, it's called at the perfect time. It's an all-out blitz. It's cover 0. That means every FIU guy has a responsibility. There's no safety. And as you run it, Robinson does a great job of holding on to this football at the last minute. And then you have right guard Christian Hayes. But the key are these blocks right here. It's so hard sometimes for these receivers to get blocks downfield on screens. But both of them, Porter and Jolie, do an excellent job of locking onto their man, locking onto that defender, and staying on them the entire time. Excellent call. I tell you what, there's not a better time to call a screenplay than off a blitz. More importantly, cover 0 when there's no safety help whatsoever.
Robinson's first touchdown pass of the day. Ball spotted back a bit. First down run play. Not much there for Lawrence at all. Snuffed out quickly by UConn's defense. Momentum squarely with the Huskies now. Jenkins, the star QB in the third quarter. Christian, only 2 of 7 and 20 passing yards as the offense got slowed down a bit by some good defense from UConn in the third.
Yeah, and I tell you what, this is when, if you want to get the nickname and have the nickname lights up, this is when you have to deliver.
Jenkins breaks a tackle. McCarthy couldn't bring it down. They slides ahead. In front Devontae Jones does have the first down gain of 9. It's where the slide starts is where you mark him down. Officials give him the first.
Yeah, and you know what? He likes to say that he patterns his game after Cam Newton. Now, Cam Newton would go run right into this defender head first like a fullback. But Jenkins a little smarter than that because he's not nearly as big as Cam Newton. But he gets the first down. He gets a fresh set of downs. And, you know, and this is what's important right now. Not the big chunk play, chewing up the clock, getting first downs, keeping these drives going.
The freshman's 5'11", 190. Thinking about measurables, pressure off the edge. And incomplete. Good throw. Artez Hooker couldn't bring it in, though. Little behind him, a couple balls in the second half. Catchable drops for FIU.
Yeah, and I thought this was thrown. This is really his, maybe he's probably had two bad passes. Maybe it's the sun, not sure, but it's definitely behind him. That's not indicative of how accurate or how good he is as a passer. Or maybe he was trying to save his receiver just by knowing that the safety is right there, could have made a contact on the receiver.
Arm strength, not an issue with this guy.
No.
Second down. Jenkins. A little wobbly ball, intended for Fournay, and it's incomplete. Chris Sheeran, the redshirt junior, Suffolk, Virginia, had a shot at a pick, and it falls incomplete. Panthers continue to struggle here offensively in the second half. Big third down conversion on the way.
Yeah, and that was a double move right there by the receiver. And he waits for him. It's almost like a hook and go, but it's more of a slant. And that was a good job by Sheeran, actually almost waiting on it so he couldn't come back around. Excellent job defensively by UConn.
Looked like Sequoia McDuffie up front. The Old Dominion transfer got a piece of that. That's why it was so wobbly. Reflected the line of scrimmage. Jenkins incomplete on 8 of 9 passes. Third down, big play. The freshman is flushed. Throws on the move. Delivers a perfect pass for Bracy. A first down conversion for FIU. Gain of 14 at Jalen Bracy as Jenkins extends the play.
Yeah, when we started the game, you know, I said he's got a little Houdini in him. This reminds me of Brett Favre a little bit, the way he kind of scrambles, buys himself some time. Gets that first down, keeps the play alive. This is what you need from your all-star quarterback. You know, when they take away every single option, you just got to make the best out of it and find a way to get it done, and finds the open receiver. And again, a new, fresh set of downs.
So important. First down, you can run the ball with Lawrence if you want. Play fake instead. Design QB draw. Jenkins, elusive. Jenkins, not that elusive. Air quads catch him. Flags fly from all directions, though. And a face mask looks like it's on the way, and an automatic first down for FIU.
Yeah, that's got to be and you know, he'll take it. You can see him right there. He'll take it.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 95. That 15-yard penalty, of course, in the previous spot, first down.
You know, scrambling is such a big part of his game, and not like this is what he wants to do, but he is good at it. And watch the face mask come in late, right hand right there. There it is right there. Big number 95, Eric Watts. I don't think everyone ever intentionally tries to grab a face mask. Personally, I don't think so.
Flags fly from all directions. You know what that call is, right? Lawrence feature back. Lawrence team's leader in sacks last year at 7 on the bowl team for UConn. Lawrence, good move. Gets by Jones and gets stood up and sent backwards. Jamari Lawrence is tackled by Jackson Mitchell.
Yeah, he shoots the gap, and, you know, the tight end gets just enough of him just kind of so he can't get both hands on him. But good finish by number 4, Stan Cross.
Yeah, great tackle.
Wow. I mean, a big stop right here for, at the worst, you want to just hold him to a field goal. And the one thing UConn has not done is they haven't gotten a turnover yet. I mean, the only 2 sacks on the year so far. They had one today, but not one pick. One fumble recovered, but no picks.
Yeah, one takeaway, 2 games, not going to do it. Lawrence runs right. Jamari Lawrence with a flag down. First play coming back. Another flag flies. Devontae Jones, the hit.
We got 2 flags.
And Ben Wahan involved as well. Let's see with 2 calls what we got.
Well, they are hitting a lot harder now, we'll tell you that much. I can hear it up here in the booth. I mean, depending on the.
There are multiple fouls committed on the play. Holding, offense, number 56. Personal foul, targeting, defense, number 2. That foul is being. Those penalties were offset.
Jadarius Lee, the holding call, and Durante Jones targeting, so automatically we go to replay.
Well, you know, there's a couple of criteria. Here it is right here. It's full speed right here. Yeah. Now, if you watch, is he leading with the crown of his helmet? Looks like it. That's a violent hit right there. That takes guts right there to stop Lawrence, but I don't know how else you're supposed to stop him, but the crown of the helmet, he's not a defenseless player because Lawrence is running downhill. So, of course, Jones is ejected from the game.
If it's upheld with video replay.
Yeah.
Now, Jones actually, I'm not sure if it's Jones or Wahad who is initially flagged there because Wahad had the initial contact. Jones had the finish. I don't think it's on Jones, although Art Brown did say number two Jones. So it's very important as we see the criteria here to clarify which player is involved exactly. Both had physical hits there. Let's take a look again.
Yeah. All right. So there's the first hit right there.
That's been Wahad.
Okay.
That's, I think, the targeting possibility.
Okay. You're right.
And not,
you know,
Jones.
I had the wrong number. No, you're right. Yeah.
That's the crown of the helmet.
Yeah.
I don't know if they're going to. That's a dangerous
play.
Yeah. Mumbu bin Wahad, the transfer from West Virginia. I'm guessing partner is going to get upheld. He'll be ejected.
Yeah. And to be honest with you,
so that'll be an automatic first down, first and goal here for FIU if it's in fact a targeting call.
I know the rule is the rule, but I mean, Lawrence was leaning with his head as well. I mean, I don't know what you're supposed to do with that. Your track was not to hit him in his head. He lowered his head and ran into you as you were going. If I'm the defensive back, if I'm the defender, I don't know what my recourse is. I mean,
and it's really important to clarify which player we're talking about here. That's Durante Jones.
Yeah,
I don't think he's the one whistled.
That's not him.
Penalty.
No, it's number six. That was
right.
My bad on that, but
that's
the wrong number.
Yeah.
But it's clearly number six, Mumu. There he is right there. And
junior from Atlanta. Went to Grayson High School, that incredible high school football area, state champion. Big key defensive back for Jim Mora. Let's get the call.
After further review, the personal foul, targeting foul, was on defense number six. Number six is disqualified. Both penalties were offset in the second half.
Yeah, so the refs had it wrong, too. Look, there I go listening to the refs. I should use my eyes.
And Ben Wahad is very frustrated.
Well, yeah, because he's got to sit out next week, too. And they're
first half next week against Duke. Undefeated Duke comes here. So that's a key loss. He can't play until the second half next week because this occurs in the second half today.
Yep.
And it's an automatic first down for FIU.
And there's not even any, you know, hey, let's challenge this, during the Monday and Tuesday.
Offsetting penalties, so no automatic first down. Second and three. But the ejection for Ben Wahad, he and Debon Brinson play that corner for Jim Mora. Big penalty. Feature back Lawrence. Jenkins, mesh play, keeps the freshman, Noah Platt. Has him from behind. Third down coming up.
Yeah, and I wonder right now, so it's third down. Now they've gone, FIU has gone for it on fourth down six times this year. So I sit there and I go, okay, they're down seven. So they're up seven. They've had a pretty good job. I wonder, on a third down call, is this third down call based on with them already committing to going for it on fourth down, or would you just be happy with an extra point, a field goal?
FIU 3-6, partner, on those six attempts on fourth down. If it comes down to it, third down here. Lawrence feature back. Big play for the Panthers. Broken up. Almost caught. Yates had the breakup. There's no whistle yet. Noah Plack has got it for UConn. If that's the call, it's Husky ball here.
Was that not a pass?
I sure thought it was a forward pass. Let's see here. Sort this out.
Okay, there's the hand. There's the fake hand up. That's it. No.
Incomplete. Incomplete. That's not a fumble. Noah Plack you do that, you don't hear the whistle, you pick it up and run.
Yeah.
That's what you're coached to do. But the bottom line is, it's not a sudden change. Wishful thinking there for the Husky fans. It is fourth down for Mike McIntyre. He's thinking field goal.
Yeah, and it's a two-possession game either way, so it makes sense.
Up by 10. Chase Gabriel, Junior, Brunswick, Georgia.
Probably a good time for a block. Block PAT.
Be a great time for UConn. This from 33. Made one already from 27 today. Punter Montiel, the holder for Mike McIntyre. Missed it! Wide left and no good, not close for Chase Gabriel. Huskies hold. Still a 7-point game.
Well, I feel like I jinxed him, but I said block it, not hook it left. And there you go. He just kind of pushes it to his left. McIntyre, oh man, you watch him. He's like, what a wasted opportunity. Hopefully that won't come back to bite him.
After Advil dual action back pain.
Yo! Ooh, ha, ha. What?
My back feels better.
Before Advil. Oh. New Advil dual action back pain fights back pain two ways for 8 hours of relief.
You want to be like me? Well, you can't. Because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me. Always. Every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you proud. You want to stay proud, right?
Hello, welcome to T-Town. Like men over 40 everywhere. These guys experience a drop in testosterone. Don't worry, it happens to all of us. Some guys took my advice about how to boost their testosterone, and some didn't. This guy got the message loud and clear.
That's right, Nugenix Total T.
Nugenix Total T is the unique patented formula powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to boost free testosterone to help you feel stronger, leaner, with more muscle and drive. Nugenix is number one doctor recommended, number one at GNC, and number one at Walmart. But you can only get your complimentary bottle by texting RIGHT to 42424.
Thanks. It'll make you feel like a new man. And by the way, she'll like it too.
Get your complimentary bottle of Nugenix now. Text RIGHT to 42424. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo X, our newest, most powerful fat incinerator ever. Absolutely free.
Meetings in 20. I'm fine, I'll follow the GPS.
Turn left here.
Oh, can't be.
Proceed along the route.
Are you certain?
Turn right.
Are you for imprint certain?
Arrived.
Certainty matters, like the certainty of ordering items from the promotional product professionals at 4imprint.
Arrived!
To show your appreciation to clients, coworkers, and customers, make your destination 4imprint.com.
4imprint, for certain.
In all three games this year, Christian, UConn shut out in the second quarter, but the second half, a different story today.
Yeah, they started off with the first series in the second half, getting a touchdown, and obviously defense has been so important, not letting Jenkins scramble and get positive yardage. And of course, the second touchdown of the second half, the big screen play by Devontae Houston with the great block by Christian Hayes and Joel Lee and Porter. That's been the difference of the game.
One score game from East Hartford. This field goal critical for FIU. Roberson, the offense. Design sprint right, thinking about Houston. And it throws it to the sideline. Porter. Trying to bring that in.
Yeah, that was just, you know, these are the things where I'm sitting as I'm watching Roberson play. Now he's covered tightly, but he needs to throw it earlier. He holds on to the ball. When you do these waggle routes, these sprint right plays, sprint left plays, you get to the edge, you get to like that tackle spot, you get rid of it right away.
Second half, a lot better for Jim Moore's team. A 180. Incomplete pass a moment ago to Porter, the grad student from Rancho Cucamonga, California's third stop, Arizona State of the Pac-12 and New Mexico of the Mountain West. Second down. Houston, flag flies. Almost though was holding territory, but let's find out.
We don't jump to conclusions, but whatever that flag throws thrown at the feet, feels like it's always holding.
Holding. Offense. number 64. 10-yard penalty, second down.
Preseason third-team All-American Christian Haynes.
Yeah, let's see what happens. Well, that's Jack Daly. That's his move. That's Daly's move. He loves the up and over swim move. And the thing is that Hayes didn't really even need to grab him at all, really, because the play was going away.
40 starts in a row for the All-American. Third player in program history to earn that honor last year. 2022 six-win bowl team. A turnaround from one win in 2021. Didn't play in 2020. Jim Mora, known for turning programs around. Great coach. Second down at the holding call. Houston set up. Instead, rubber sent with some pressure. Gets away near the goal line. Dancing near the sideline and gets that out of bounds. He's facing all kinds of heat again from Nobles and Garrod in pursuit.
This is such
of a QB.
Such a dangerous, dangerous play. Now he gets the
That was close.
Yeah, no, I know. It's such a dangerous play.
Almost stepped out.
It's so dangerous.
And Jim Mora can't even watch now. I mean, it's tough.
I mean, you just throw it away. Again, it's third down. There's 9 minutes left. Your defense is playing lights out.
Roberson. Pressure again off the edge. Pass more Emmanuel in pursuit. And Manuel escorts him out of bounds again.
Yeah, that's just a really good sound tackle right there by Manuel. And he's now Robertson. I know he's a quarterback and he's probably fast, but not nearly as fast as Manuel. And there's Huff, Avery Huff on the side. And Nobles is having a great game right now, getting around the edges, chasing plays down on run plays. And Manuel there to clean it up. Now this is when you need the big punt.
Catamaran. Releases from his three. Patterson from the 44 gathers and runs into trouble. 4 yard return, Dean Patterson. 44 yards.
Hey, David, ready to get started?
Work with advisors who create a plan with you and help you find the right investments.
So great getting to know you. Let's take a look at your new investment plan.
Okay, great.
This should have you moving in the right direction.
Thanks, Jen.
Get ongoing advice and manage your investments in the Chase mobile app.
Sometimes all you need to change your life is a sign. Like an actual sign that's like above you. And no, I don't love B-dubs just because I'm a buffalo with wings. Frankly, that's offensive and reductionist. It's like they made beer into a place and gave that place sports and chicken wings. And the people, the best.
Marty! You're dead weight!
Yeah, this place is kind of like heaven. You know, without needing to get hit by a bus. Let's go, sports bar!
Let's get to work. Someone's in the system.
It's a cyber attack. We have to do something.
Let all the secrets come out.
I am offering you a lifeline.
You're selling UBA to Paul Marks.
He's ruthless. I made a huge mistake.
You broke every rule.
How do you sit in that chair every night?
Be like me? Well, you can't, because there's only one Brad. But you can recover like me, always, every day. They can help you recover from exercise to keep you. They prime, right?
You're watching College Football on CBS Sports Network, presented by the Home Depot. One score game. Young fans enjoying the action here today. Coming up next, more college football on the way. Vanderbilt of the SEC takes on UNLV on the Mountain West at Allegiant Stadium in Vegas. Then at 10:30 Eastern, we wrap it up with Kansas coming off a big win over Illinois last week. Facing off against Nevada of the Mountain West. Catch it all here On CBS Sports Network, C.J. Taylor leads 2-1 Vandy. 25 tackles and 3 sacks Taylor made. Mike McIntyre played for his dad, George, at Vanderbilt for a couple years. George, the National Coach of the Year, 82. Flags fly everywhere before this play gets going here for FIU.
False start. Offense, number 55. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Wyatt Lawson. Guilty party, right guard. Remember, Jacob Peace was hurt early in the game. As Cal told us about, starting right guard for Mike McIntyre. Coach McIntyre, Coach Moore know each other very well. Way back to their Pac-12 days. Both coaches' sons. This game means a lot to each. On first down, run play. Not much there.
John Owens.
Jelani Stafford continues a big day, partner. Big day.
He is a madman right now. I love it. Look at him. He can't stop.
It's fun to watch. It's fun to watch. Second and long.
He's just talking. I saw him pacing earlier again, like in the huddle, talking to the offense, barking at the defense, barking at the other offense.
Second and long. Play fake. Jenkins, pressure, Yates, there he goes. Press Yates, hits a sack for UConn. And a freshman knocked down, loss of 8.
An assist goes to the defensive backs with the great coverage, but Yates really gets free so quickly, right off the bat. Beats one of their best offensive linemen, Travis Burke. 6'9", 290 pounds off the left side. When we talked to McIntyre, we asked him who his best offensive lineman was. And it was number 77, Yates, with the timely sack.
Third and really long here. Third and 21 for the Panthers. Whistles first.
Delay a game. Offense, number 1. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Panthers imploding here. They're back up 5 more yards on the delay of game call.
Yeah, they had the offsides to start the drive, a sack, and now you have a delay of game. So I don't know how many plays you have for 3rd and 26.
Get a decent chunk and punt, probably. Jenkins, QB draw, but it gives us that. The freshman is elusive. Jackson Mitchell tripped him up just enough. One of the nation's leading tacklers does get 12 yards back. So a decent amount of real estate for the punt coming up here for the Panthers.
Yeah, you don't really have many options. I mean, you don't think you're going to get the first down. It's 26 yards. You're just hoping you can get yourself in better field position when you punt and hopefully, you know, make this a field position game, especially with the fact that you're up and there's a little over 6 minutes left in the game. And there's Buckman actually dropped the punt last week. Bobbled it. North Texas recovered it.
Seventh of the day coming up here for Montiel. 15th overall in the game. That's a lot of punts. Buckman makes a fair catch at about 22. And UConn gets it back in a one-score game. Another chance for the Huskies on offense when we return.
Hey, Coach, I brought Tostitos.
Why is Micah Parsons here?
Team, war room now.
Whoa.
You ain't seen nothing yet, Judy.
Let's go. I need more urgency, Coach. So when is everyone coming?
The party is until next week.
We make a great team.
When the world of business is constantly changing, you need to stay ahead. So what about AI to generate new possibilities? Machine learning to predict what customers will like. Or expand your business by forecasting delivery routes with real-time data. With the most experience in the cloud, imagine how AWS can transform your business.
Having health insurance is important. So if anyone in your family has Medicaid or CHIP,
Listen up. Check the mail for your renewal form. Complete the form. And mail it back right away so you don't lose your coverage. If you do lose your coverage, visit healthcare.gov to see if you're eligible to enroll in a low-cost, quality health plan. Healthcare.gov.
Cracked windshield on your new car? You don't have to take it to the dealer. Bring it to SafeLight. We do more replacements and recalibrations than anyone else.
Thank you so much.
Schedule now.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replace.
All right, Chris, let's review your keys to the game here today.
Well, this is for FIU. It stopped the run. Well, they scored. They had 295 yards rushing last year, UConn did. So I guess holding them to 133 is better. And how about for UConn? Contain Jenkins. Well, they didn't do it in the first half. But in the second half, they have actually doing an excellent job. Pass incomplete. Passions.
Houston's numbers today. Now that screen pass and the touchdown. Second half. Again, the Huskies a chance to tie it. Fourth quarter. Houston looks for Allen. Reggie Peterson has a tackle for FIU.
And Devontae Houston has been such a key. Remember last year he had 135 total yards against this FIU defense, but he's doing it on the ground, he's doing it through the air, and they just keep going to him. Here's the screen play. This is a huge call, big play in this game, lots of blocking downfield. He's really doing everything for this team right now.
First career touchdown catch for Devontae Houston, one of the fastest Huskies. Junior from Roanoke, Alabama. Team second lead rusher behind Victor Rosa last year.
Whenever we talk to this team,
game clock operator, please set the game clock to 5 minutes and 38 seconds. The clock will start on my signal. Thank you.
Huskies lose 10 seconds there. 6.7 per carry for Houston today, nearing 100 yards. Carries again, has 100. CJ Christian, the touchdown saving tackle, first down UConn. Big run, Devontae Houston, chains move, Huskies on the move themselves.
And he did such a good job of, watch, I mean, Jack Daly goes into the backfield, he goes around him and just finds a way. Nobody does a better job of getting downfield than Devontae Houston.
Gain of 10, big first down for the Huskies. Goalie in motion, pitch play, it's Houston again. Looks for room left. Player strung out nicely. Great pursuit tackle. Alex Nobles sideline to sideline.
Yeah.
With the fantastic stop for the Panthers.
Yeah, he's been doing that all day. He's doing an excellent job of chasing down all these UConn backs. And this time for UConn, they're just trying to get Houston with a running start, get to that edge quicker than they would by handing the football off to him. But Nobles doing such a good job pursuing, slows it down a little bit.
109 rushing yards of the day for Houston. Second down. Play fake. Roberson keeps. Christian says no. CJ Christian read it and puts him down. A great tackle in the open space there for FIU.
Yeah, that was a really good job, and we talked about it. Now they're just going to run a raw RPO, but he decides to keep it. But I don't think Buckman kind of – I think Buckman was kind of a little, unsure about what was happening because he didn't block Christian, and Christian ended up making the play.
Big third down, 36 for Jim Mora. All three timeouts remaining. Possible four down territory near midfield. Let's see. Big conversion on the way here. Roberson. Here comes the pressure. Doubles again. Roberson thinking about the sticks. He's short of that, though. Reggie Peterson runs him out of bounds. Manual the pressure, too. Big play coming up here, Chris.
Yeah, I don't think you can give it back to him. I don't think you can give it. I know the last five drives for FIU, the last five drives, you've had three straight punts. You'd have a missed field goal. Then you had another punt. So this is what Moore's going to do. He's going to rely on his defense to get him the ball back. The crowd does not like it, to be honest with you. I don't really like it. But I think this is more having faith in his defense, playing five straight series where they played great football.
Roberson on the sideline for now. Patterson, fair catch inside his 10. And now 3:08 to go. Huskies do have all three timeouts. 48-yard punt from Caratan. Can the freshman Jenkins close out the game? Lights out has not been the same. Lights have been flickering, Christian, in the second half here.
Yeah, I know, and I know we talk about, you know, Moore and just his, you know, having trust in his defense. It could be that he doesn't have any confidence in his offense. Where I would say at some point in time, you're going to have faith in them. But I feel like he has more faith in his defense. They're backed up. Okay, they've had five great possessions of defense. They're sacking him. They're knocking passes down. They're doing everything right. So he'd rather rely on his defense and his three timeouts that they'll get him the ball back again.
It was 4th and 3 near midfield. Risky call to punt it. Lawrence stops. Stafford continues the big game.
There's that man.
There's that man.
The runner knee was down. Second down.
Official timeout. Shamari Lawrence is slow to get up, and that hurts FIU in a couple ways. The clock stops. And one of their best running backs is shaken up.
Oh,
that right leg. Woo. FIU trainers out to attend to Shamari Lawrence. We'll be back in 30 seconds.
30 seconds.
Old Trapper Beefs. Oh, one upping.
I'm a big Old Trapper fan.
Not bigger than me. I love Old Trapper.
I love how tender it is.
Don't forget the wood smoke flavor.
What about the clear bag?
That shows you exactly what you're getting.
Savory beef.
Quality ingredients. I'm their biggest fan.
Old Trapper, what's your beef?
Will you sign my bag and my tattoo?
Dramatic finish on the way here. 2:59 to go, fourth quarter. A moment ago, Christian Lawrence shaking up.
Well, the good news is that he's walking off the field, but Stafford does a great job of beating two blockers. And watch when he grabs him, kind of twists, and his knee gets caught. Oh, no. That doesn't look good. He coughs up the football, but they ruled him down. But he's walking off, and I'm sure everybody's happy about that.
Standing sophomore, Pompano Beach in South Florida. Not far from the Miami-based FIU campus.
Game clock operator, please set the game clock to 3 minutes and 2 seconds. Game clock operator, please set the game clock to 3 minutes and 2 seconds.
FIU used a timeout there a moment ago. They've got two left. Second half. We've got another official timeout here.
Game clock operator, please set the game clock to 3 minutes and 2 seconds. The timeout was on University of Connecticut. That's their first.
No.
They should have two timeouts left.
Called by UConn, not FIU.
They should have three timeouts left.
I think the game clock operator and the refs need to have a quick little chat.
UConn called the timeout.
Okay.
To be clear, not FIU. That's big. All right. The loss of two on the run to Lawrence. He did not fumble it. He's helped
off. FIU has three timeouts. University of Connecticut has two timeouts.
Mark Brown clarifies the timeout situation. Big play again for the 18-year-old Kewan Jenkins. And a Miami hometown hero. Brilliant in the first half. Limited in the second. Now trying to finish the game. From his end zone, he throws. Reception and a big one. Catch made. Eric Rivers overcoming a hand injury. We do have a timeout call. Big third down the way. Back in 30 seconds.
You know, they say losing hope, that's the real disaster. Last year, Tropical Storm Fred sent a devastating wall of water and debris down this river. And when the waters receded, Belfour was here. not just to rebuild, but to help restore the life of this community. Belfour, restoring more than property.
Timeout a moment ago. UConn has one timeout left here in the second half. Third down coming up for IU, trying to finish this game.
Yeah, the missed field goal would have made it a two-possession game. Not even close. Not even close. Keeps UConn in the game. McIntyre just can't believe it. Big down right here for the UConn defense.
Huge miss by Chase Gabriel. Dayton Montiel, the punter, preps punting into the net here. Roberson leading the charge on the UConn bench. Huskies need it. First, we got whistles and flags.
This is going to be interesting.
Five more yards.
Because you're not allowed to flinch and draw the offensive line off. But this is what Jelani Stafford and this defensive line, they go laterally. They don't flinch. Let's see what they say.
False start. Offense, number 85. 5-yard penalty, third down.
The tight end, Jackson McDonald.
Okay, this was brilliant by this defensive front. Watch them all. They see them all in unison go. And as soon as they do it, you're not allowed to jerk and flinch and draw the offense offside. So instead, in unison together, they go laterally. Very bright move right there by that defensive front. Gave him an extra 5 yards.
Huge penalty. Stretches it out to 3rd and 7 for the true freshman. Got 4 wideouts to choose from here. Huskies need a stop. Neiman in motion. Trouble with the exchange. Hits loose and fumble. Who's got it? FIU recovers. Flirting with disaster on the exchange fumble with a running back there in Keyjohn Owens.
Calls their third and final timeout.
This looked really similar to earlier in the second half, right? Remember when he fumbled the ball earlier, fell on top of it. The center snapped it to the left of where the back was. And again, he took his eyes off the ball briefly, and the ball hits the turf.
Unbelievable. Bad snap in between Keyjohn Owens and Jenkins, who heads up play, hops on it. Timeout called UConn and Jim Morisseau. Remember, elected to go for the punt on 4th and 3 from near midfield. Going to get the ball back here.
Well, he absolutely made
time,
the right.
But no timeouts.
Yeah, he absolutely made it. Listen, for me, I was like, I don't know if I just, but it just shows that the trend was going, that his defense was playing lights out. Not to steal, you know, Kiwan's, nickname, but they were playing lights out, and obviously they were making all the right calls. So he's going to get his offense the ball back with 0 timeouts, 2 minutes and 40, a little over 2 minutes and, 35 seconds left in the game.
Montiel backed up to the end line of the end zone here. Bachman hoping for a big return. Dave Montiel, good kick. Here's Bachman. Fair caught. At the 48, 42-yard punt. Not sure why. I would return that.
Oh, yeah.
For sure. To gain some real estate.
I look at what happened to him last week, the fact that he caught that one up, and I feel like he's a little nervous and doesn't want to chance it. But he's been doing this all game where he fair catches it quickly.
Yard line, no timeouts, 2:41 to go in the fourth, and the Huskies a chance to tie it. Roberson back in the starting lineup after missing a year with an ACL tear. Houston, a cut. Devontae Houston, first down, then some. Deverick Daniel has the stop defensively for FIU. First down to the 34, gain of 14 for Houston, continuing a big day.
Yeah, they got to hurry up and get to the line of scrimmage. Remember, the rules have changed. Inside 2 minutes in the fourth quarter, the clock will stop, but not until inside 2 minutes.
First down, Houston again. Looks right. Stopped there by Nobles, the first to get to him.
Eventually, they're going to have to throw the football down the field in order to save some clock time because they don't have any timeouts left.
No clock stops on first downs. Inside 2 minutes. Roberson. Think about Buckman deep with blades on coverage. Here comes the pass interference flag. Gonna be an automatic first down. Brian Blades and Buckman got tangled up on the deep ball.
This is an interesting call right here because Buckman fights to get back inside, and that's an obvious hold. You can't grab him. He fights across the defender's face. He holds him, and that, yeah, they're not going to plead for that call. That's not going to happen. He doesn't let it go. That's Brian Blades, cornerback, redshirt sophomore. They're going to talk about it right now, but I don't know how they can pick this flag up unless they got another one somewhere else laying on the ground.
I thought Buckman might have interfered first, but then Blades did it last.
Pass interference, defense, number 22, 15-yard penalty, first down.
Big call, first down Huskies.
Now Buckman may get away with something right here. Watch his left hand as he kind of, incidental, I know, but sometimes they'll call it still. They fight through it. UConn may have gotten away with one. That could have been offsetting, right?
That was a lot of contact for Buckman.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Well, the hands to the face is the one that usually gets, you know, kind of grabs every ref and forces it.
Huge call. First down. Oh, they move. Lots of movement. False start backs up the Huskies. 5. Four penalties, 30 yards for FIU in the fourth.
False start. Offense, number 62. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Plus 5 penalties there for UConn.
I think they both moved. I think Valentin Sen moved also. They just called it on 62. he gets his name called out.
Well, Afori Liadu, senior from Arlington in the Dallas Metroplex.
Just watch number 17, Justin Jolie, the way they use him. There he is right here. Remember, the slant route is something that they go to from him in the slot whenever they need a big play. They've been doing it from him flexed out to the wide side of the field.
First down, Houston. Evades one tackle, Emmanuel Ware. So good in pursuit sideline to sideline. One of the nation's leading tacklers, Donovan Manuel. Nice play.
Yeah, he's so quick. And you know, listen, they've been running that stretch play a lot, and even number 8 gets through the line. Jeremy Passmore.
No timeouts for the Huskies. Gotta have a touchdown. Minute 46. Overson, the redshirt junior, Orange, New Jersey, back in the starting lineup after missing a whole year with an ACL tear. It's quite a story. Wants a good ending here. Passes over the middle. Buckman's got it. Run up by Manuel. Big tackle, but gets to the 15. Not enough for the first down.
Somebody's down, too.
Manuel slow to get up. That was quite a collision. Number 10 on number 10.
Official's timeout for an injured defensive player.
Best defender for FIU down now being treated by Panther trainers. Back in 30 seconds.
At Consumer Cellular, we offer amazing 5G coverage backed up by incredible customer service. But that wouldn't mean much without super low prices.
You already know we're up to half as much as the largest carriers. But guess what? AARP members can save even more.
Yahoo!
Switch to Consumer Cellular now and get unlimited talk and text with a flexible data plan starting at only $20 a month. For a limited time, switch and get your second month free.
10 tackles, 2 TFLs for Manuel. The star, Mike Backer for FIU, taken off by Panther Trainers. That's actually very important in this huge drive. All right, here we go, Christian. 3rd and 8. 2 plays to get that first down or maybe a touchdown for
you. Well, yeah, you got to assume. You got to have 2 plays called in the huddle right now. The whole offense is lined up right now with Nick Charlton, offensive coordinator. You got to call 2 plays because what you don't want to do is, you know, if you don't get the first down, the clock is not stopping, right? So let's just save as much time as possible. Have 2 calls ready to go. If you don't get the first down, give me your best call to your best player. That is what I want. And let's see. So remember now, FIU earlier went up for the all-out zero blitz. Now, watch the safeties. If you feel like you get man coverage, you take the shot. If it's there, you take it.
Husky trying to win number 1 of the year. Big play here, partner. On 3rd down for Roberson. delivers. Buckman, the catch.
No, they're running the clock.
Daniel has the tackle, but it's not enough for the first down to get to the 11. Clock is rolling. Here comes the game.
Yeah, but you don't have to panic right now. You still got a lot of time, and you can still get the ball, get it out of bounds. If you get a first down, you're good because you get a first down, the clock stops. But this is the game right here.
Fourth and four, Huskies have got to have it. FIU trying to close it out on the road. Here's the play of the game. Roberson flushed. Roberson rolls right. Flag flies to the end zone. Jolie has got it. It's a touchdown. It's a touchdown for UConn, but there is a flag down at the 22. Let's check out the call.
Holding. Offense. It's coming number back. 75. 10-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Oh, it's Chase Lunt, right tackle. Oh, yeah, he just, I mean, well, you can't do that. But I know why he did, because, hell, I might as well just hold him. And that was a beautiful catch. That was a beautiful throw. But the holding call, I don't know if Jeremy Passmore was going to get him anyways. Now, let's see if his foot was even in. Let's see.
Really close.
That's really close. Can't
I don't know.
Really tell by that angle.
We'll never know if it'll
the
be upheld by
replay.
Previous play
is under further review for whether or not the receiver caught the ball in bounds.
All right, so we'll get the review. There is a holding call against UConn. That first look partner, I don't think he had it in. I think he was dragging from near the paint personally. Let's see.
And from that angle, yeah, I couldn't tell. I didn't see any grass or anything. Let's see if we see it. Here's the... Still can't see it.
Not from that angle. You can't see it again. The prior angle, our great crew,
I'm watching the ref, too, to see if he's signaling anything. There he is.
Possession.
There he is right there. He's looking right at it. He doesn't want to say anything.
It's a tough one there.
But
here's the look you want.
Look, he's right there. There's the ref right there.
Yeah, but no foot is down. No foot is down yet, I don't think. Do you see space between
Not the drag?
Oh, is that close? I don't know if he made contact in bounds before he got to the paint. He did have possession of the ground. What a catch by Joe.
There he goes. He had to think about it.
What a catch. Joe Ryder, the replay official here at Rensselaer Field.
Here you go. Here's your look right here. I think his foot's in. I mean, if he signaled touchdown, he's not going to overrule it. And there's, you know, there's still a holding penalty. So, you know, I mentioned to you before that play that, you know, find your best player, your most consistent player. Even though Jolie had a couple drops earlier, that's the guy they want to go to. That's the guy that always gets the mismatches. You know, he's bigger than any DB, and he can run faster than any linebacker.
CJ Christian on coverage. Looks like the feet are airborne there, partner.
Yeah, absolutely.
Is it down? That's close. I don't know.
If this is the only angle they're using, the touchdown holds up, but the holding penalty is going to give him another shot. Right?
There's left foot contact, inbounds. There's daylight.
Oh, we see now this one. At the end, how are they going to tell what's going on?
That's
incredibly not
close.
Conclusive to you, is it? That's not conclusive to me. I say it holds up.
Conclusive video evidence has to be ruled here by the officials to overturn the call on the field, which is a touchdown, but there also is the holding call for UConn. So
it's fourth down either way. If they give him the touchdown and they it's going to be fourth down and right now what Nick Charlton is doing is, okay, what's our best play? And you're still going to have time, so you don't need a touchdown. You still just need a first down.
It's a great point. First down to the 7.5-yard line. No timeouts, but 58 seconds, so don't need the touchdown.
How do you feel when they take this long to look at it? Do you feel that's for the receiver? In this case,
I think it's for the receiver.
Here we go.
Let's get the call.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. The holding penalty is enforced. It is fourth down.
Fourth holding call of the game against UConn. None more damaging than that one. What a catch by Jolie. But all for naught. So here we go again. Another play of the game for UConn in a must-do.
Yeah, in this situation, your defensive line, if your FIU has done a pretty good job, I'd be amazed if they sent a blitz. What I'm looking at is four guys rushing covering with seven. Yeah, you got to drop seven. You got to think that he can see if he can find the open guy.
Huskies have got to have it here.
Oh, they come with the blitz.
Here comes some pressure. Roberson delivers. Perfect pass. Ross has got it. Where's the spot? He didn't get there. It's short. FIU holds. And the Panthers are going to win here today at East Hartford. Shy by about a yard on the Ross reception. And FIU takes over on downs.
Well, they rushed five with a late rusher on the back end. And they wanted to force him to throw it quick. And it's Cam Ross with the quick in route, and it's just quite not deep enough. I tell you what, in this situation, if you're Cam Ross, if you need 11, you got to go 12. If you need 9, you got to go 10. He catches the ball. It's tight coverage. He catches it, and he falls down, but he's short.
It'll be the first 3-1 Panther start since 2017. It'll be their first three-game win streak since 2019. So history made, Mike McIntyre, the turnaround king. He's done now three schools. And FIU is going to win on the road here in the second ever matchup with UConn, first game ever played here in East Hartford with these two teams. Huskies, bitterly tough defeat here tonight with 21st-ranked Duke undefeated coming here next week.
Yeah, for UConn, you're really in it. You put yourself in a really bad spot.
Old rivals from the Pac-12 from their UCLA and Colorado days meet again here in East Hartford. And Mike McIntyre gets the better of Jim Moore. 24-17 is the final. FIU is 3-1. And the freshman quarterback, Kewan Jenkins, 3-0 as a starter. For Christian Fourier, Keanu Martin, the entire crew, it's Dave Ryan saying so long from Rensselaer Field. It's been a presentation of CBS Sports Network, the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. We'll send you down to Las Vegas for Vanderbilt, UNLV. So long from East Hartford. Panthers, yes, the Panthers.